Okay, in that case, IFMSA Executive Board, would you like to withdraw this motion before we move forward?
Okay, that's fine with us. We withdraw this motion. If everyone is comfortable.
Thank you, IFMSA VPA. This motion is therefore withdrawn. Okay, moving forward, I have received, as previously discussed over the NMO server, I'm now opening a speakers list. This is in relation to the LIMSA Lithuania's concern over election practices. So this is a topic that is going to be concerned right now. I will give the floor to anybody who would like to be heard on this topic. I would, however, first would like to hear from either LIMSA Lithuania or the Executive Board, the two bodies who previously sent out a message over the NMO server, as to provide us with a background on the topic for the sake of the minutes as well. So either IFMSA Executive Board or LIMSA Lithuania, I give you the floor. You can decide between each other who would like to start talking.
Thank you.
You're fine with them speaking first.
Yeah, I can read the replies we send through the NMO server. So, dear NMOs, dear EB and SUBCO, first of all, we would like to thank the EB for taking our statement into account and immediately taking measures by creating the form to report votes and rules breach. We would also like to state that this email is not against any of the elected candidates. It is a clarification of the situation. Our NMO has experience as we believe such behavior should be brought. Sorry, I have some technical issues. So I will start. We would also like to state that this email is not against any of the elected candidates. It is a clarification of the situation our NMO has experienced, as we believe such behavior should be brought to the spotlight and never be tolerated in our federation. With this email, we would like to urgently raise a concern, explain the situation, and share the proof regarding actions taken, which we believe might have impacted the elections of IFMSA officials during this online GA. Hours before the elections, LIMSA VPE was contacted over WhatsApp by a member from an NMO with an offer to join a deal regarding the exchange of votes for LIMSA LWHO candidate and LRP candidate. It was noted that at least 9 NMOs would be implicated in this exchange, thus LIMSA candidate receiving at least 9 additional votes in favor should LIMSA choose to accept, increasing chances for our LWHO candidate Mindaugas to be elected. The proof has been reported and sent to the EB. Because this proposal went against our values and beliefs, as we believe the candidates should be voted upon on their motivation and vision and not because of personal agenda or lobbying, we contacted the CCC and chair to inform them about these actions of NMO that could have a key role in elections. Later, on the same day, we decided to proceed with a statement emphasizing the importance of fair elections that was supported by 24 NMOs and read just before the elections. Even more worrying is the notion in the EB statement that there have been more NMOs who have been reporting similar practices in this GA, as 9 votes are almost 10% of total votes and could have potentially had implications in the elections of TO positions in this GA. Therefore, if any NMO is aware of any similar action taken, we urge you to report these actions to the EB. We ask all NMOs to be accountable and to uphold the democratic principles of IFMSA. We invite you to participate in this conversation, and we look forward to your inputs and thoughts on what would be the best way to proceed with this kind of situation. We would also like to ask the EB and the SUBCO how the following process of analyzing such cases would go on, as such practices are totally unacceptable, having in mind that TO is already elected and about to start the work. Thank you.
Thank you, LIMSA Lithuania. Now we're going to open the speakers list officially. If you would like to speak and be heard on this topic, please raise your hand now. LIMSA, would you still like to continue? Okay. And in Portugal, anybody else? So again, this is an official discussion right now as part of the plenary. If you would like to be heard on this topic, this is your opportunity to talk. I hope that's clear to everyone. Okay, I have to say president after Anne in Portugal. Anne, you have the floor.
Inês, Anne in Portugal.
Dear all, with this statement, we would like to present our stances as well as some reflections about extremely important topics addressed at yesterday's plenary. Regarding votes and undemocratic process allegations of IFMSA OGA elections, it is extremely worrying that colleagues, leaders, NMOs, and future health professionals actively take part in such negotiations. We, ANEM Portugal, guided by transparency, hard work, and respect towards each other's work, proudly affirm that we don't and will not engage in such agreements. Furthermore, we call on NMOs to report these actions, and we fully support the Executive Board and SUPCO efforts to prove them. Quoting Linda Lithuania's statement, we would also like to ask DB and SUPCO how the following process of analyzing such cases would go on. Regarding discussions held around Motion 91, we would like to request EB to re-watch and take it down from YouTube, as we believe the focus of the discussion ended up being more about the context and direct accusations. Having such content available online for everyone is dangerous for the image of the Federation and for the values, ideas, and vision we want to share with our members and externals. Lastly, we want to take this opportunity to truly appreciate all the efforts from IFMSATO and especially IFMSAEB to set up this amazing OGA, as well as the work from the plenary team and everyone who was involved in this assembly. Thank you.
Thank you, Anem. Next, we have IFMSA President. You have the floor.
Okay, well, I don't have a statement already, and this is an official discussion. I'll talk about the last point first regarding the discussion that happened yesterday. There is a procedural motion that exists for a debate not to be recorded in the minutes. I believe it's a procedural motion. I might be wrong. But it is also up to you, the NMOs, that when you believe that something should not be shared outside of IFMSA, outside of our own internal discussions, it's up to you to raise this as well and tell us that you would not like this to be on YouTube, you would not like this to be recorded in the minutes. So I just want to raise awareness on this, that when you feel uncomfortable with some of the discussions that are happening, because we do not have the ability to forbid anyone from speaking about anything they want in IFMSA. It is just about our own values and principles and how do we see these things. So please, in the future, whenever you see this, encounter this, mention it during the plenary itself. Regarding the points that were raised yesterday, we heard many statements surrounding the elections, surrounding the processes that you as NMOs wish to have. We discussed the matter that was brought up to us to first the IFMSA statement and later on to some of the people that approached us and decided that we needed to act, that it was important to talk about this matter because it's very serious. It is unprecedented action that was not done before. And also the EB and SUPCO, to my awareness, have not spoken about such a topic before. And as far as the future processes, we need to discuss this with the Supervising Council. As you know, Supervising Council is the only body in IFMSA that basically is able to do investigations in IFMSA. And also this was sort of our window for opportunity to raise this concern and inform everyone as we're all here present online, but still. If you have any further questions for us in this debate, we're open for it, but this is a matter of GA's decisions. This is an NMO's matter, so it is important that you are also very much involved in this.
Thank you, IFMSA President. We're going to extend the speakers list. If anybody else would like to talk, please raise your hand now. If nobody else wishes to speak, then we're going to move forward with the next point in the agenda, and this topic could be considered closed for the purposes of the General Assembly. Is that clear to everyone? Last chance if you would like to speak. IFMSA Egypt, anybody else? IFMSA Egypt, you have the floor. Then Sane DeWitt, IFMSA Supervising Council.
Okay, Mahmoud IFMSA Egypt. Would like to thank IFMSA Lithuania for raising such an important and sensitive topic that directly violates our principles and ethics that we have always taken in our federation. We just urge NMOs to be more specific when addressing such issues. The mentioning of the LRP candidate may in one way or another give a misconception that it is our LRP candidate. High levels of specificity in such issues is important to avoid such misconceptions. We, as IFMSA Egypt, highlight again the utmost importance of transparency and the importance of ethical work in all aspects. Thank you.
Thank you, IFMSA Egypt. IFMSA Supervising Council member, Sani DeWitt, you have the floor.
Thank you. I just wanted to state, since we were called upon a few times, that we will prepare things that we think can be done by us and send it over the server. But right now, we don't have the complete list written.
Sani, I barely hear you. Would it be possible that you go closer to your microphone?
I don't think so.
This is better.
Okay. Yes. Well, it was short anyways. We will send a statement over the server.
Okay, I can say sub call. We're extending the speakers list once again. If you would like to be heard on this topic, please raise your hand. Anybody other than IFMSA president? Okay, IFMSA president, you have the floor. And we're going to move forward to the next point in the agenda.
Yeah. I'll be short. IFMSAB and SUPCO statement was not directed at anyone. We need to verify any claims that are brought up to us before we can speak about anyone specifically or decide to take any actions. As SUPCO said, they're going to explain on the process, but please don't take any of the EB or SUPCO statements personally. They are just about the overall awareness that was raised, and the intentions are only behind that. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. I would like to remind everyone, the secretary team is not on the NMO server. Please make sure that you send your statements to plenary secretary and secretary-team@ifmsa.org. We need those statements for the minutes, otherwise we're going to record what the secretary assistant heard you saying here. I hope that's clear to everyone. Plenary secretary, please share your screen. Okay, we're moving forward. We have agenda point 56, adoption of the final report of the CCC. We have one motion tabled by the IFMSA Executive Board to adopt the final report of the CCC sent on 8th of August at 20:58 GMT. IFMSA EB, would you like to explain?
No explanations to share, but we would just like a clarification from CCC if this should be the second last motion or is it fine to have it here? Thank you.
I'm sorry, repeat again. The last part, so, what do you want from the CCC?
Yeah, if this should be the second last motion just before the adjournment of the General Assembly or is it fine that it's adopted right now?
Okay, this is the agenda, but IFMSA CCC, do you find any contradictions in the bylaw stating that adoption of the CCC report has to be the second to last thing happening in the General Assembly?
Hello, Michelle from CCC. No, there is no contradiction in there, but we do think that we understand the VPA that she has any concerns if the CCC final CCC report is adopted before the closing of the task force and the procedural motion of opening that agenda point and the mandates. To answer that concern, everything that is after the adoption of the CCC, the final CCC report, will not figure in it.
Okay. As we say, VPA, did you get the response that you wanted?
Can we have a 5 minutes of technical break, please? I just need to discuss this.
Okay. So we would consider this motion to not have been brought up yet, and we're going to go one step back. I have received the request to open a speakers list by the Code of Conduct Reform Task Force. Is that correct? Anais?
Yes, it is correct.
Yes. Okay, you have the floor.
Okay, I would like to read a statement on behalf of the Task Force for COC Reform. The Task Force for Code of Conduct Reform has been made aware of the current situation highlighted by IFMSA Quebec and CFMS. The Task Force of Code of Conduct Reform wants to highlight the importance of the Code of Conduct again and the work of the Task Force itself as a neutral body of the IFMSA. That being said, the task force appreciates any input on how to proceed with situations where the content of the code of conduct of the IFMSA might be involved. If a member or an NMO has ideas or input on how to proceed with situations like this, please fill out the form we have prepared and that will be sent to the NMO server. In this form, please state if your words are only meant for the internal work of the task force for COC reform or if they can be used externally. We encourage every individual member as well as entire NMOs to send us their input. Please note that we are only looking for input on the process of reporting, communicating, and following up on situations regarding the involvement of the code of conduct. We are not looking for deliberations on the specific situation itself. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Task Force Representative. Does anybody like to be heard on this topic? Raise your hand now. CCC member Michelle, would you like to speak on this topic? Or is it related to the, okay. Okay, with that, the speakers list is closed and completed. Therefore, we're once again going to move forward to the next point of the agenda. Executive Board, do you need more time?
Yes, we would require 2 more minutes, sorry.
Okay, so you get 3 more minutes and then we're going to proceed. We have a 3-minute technical break and we're going to start again.
Okay, we would like to ask SUPCO if they are submitting amended report or something that is yet to be submitted from any other IFMSA bodies, because...
Report?
Yeah, amended
report. Their report was already adopted. They cannot amend it now.
Okay.
All adopted reports, the only way to re-adopt an adopted report and then in addition to that amend it is by reopening that point to the agenda. Before that, you also have to change the agenda. So it's 2 different actions by 2 different procedural motions. Are you asking if the SUPCO is planning to do that?
Yeah, regarding the corrections that were requested.
Okay, IFMSA Supervising Council, would you like to respond to the question from the VPA?
Corrections that were requested from certain NMOs, not the executive.
I'm going to raise my hand. Can I just?
Yeah, go ahead, Satria.
Okay, IFMSA SUPCO Satria. No, we will not be submitting an amended report. We have already sent an email over the NMO server on how we plan to move forward, which does not include that.
Very well. Vibe, I imagine you still have your 2 minutes left, so we're gonna wait. I think CVP.
Yes, hi everyone. I just
don't forget we're streaming, so you cannot play anything copyrighted.
Thank you for the reminder, Peter. I just wanted to say that on the 11th, we will be having a theme event. And I'm really happy that announced that we will be having 2 UN Undersecretary Generals present, the African Union Youth Envoy, and the WHO Youth Advisor on Youth and Gender. So we are having very, very high level speakers who just confirmed their participation. I'm hoping for more surprises, but the bottom line is on the 11th, there's a very high level event organized by IFMSA. It's called a theme event. So you're welcome to join. Thank you.
Is there a motion registered?
VPA, you're bringing it up inside of the plenary. Do you want me to respond here or do you prefer talking in the chat?
Talking in the chat, because I think I must have wrongly submitted it.
Okay. Okay, executive order, are you done? Can we proceed?
Sorry, did you receive the motion?
We did receive a procedural motion just now. Okay. So done, can we proceed?
Yeah, it's registered as procedural motion, right? Not as regular motion.
No, it's registered as a regular motion. It's not a procedural motion.
I'm reformatting. Sorry.
Okay, let's have it in the meantime. Plenary Secretary, please share your screen. And VPA, mute yourself. Sorry, I have to say it. Since for the purposes of the minutes and it was submitted in the official report, the official form, therefore we have to review it. We have received a regular motion submitted by the IFMSA Executive Board to change the point in the agenda. However, as it was submitted as a regular motion, it is therefore invalid and it fails. We're waiting for the EB to submit the other motion and we're going to proceed.
I think the correct submission should be there.
Okay, and we have received a procedural motion by the IFMSA Executive Board. What a surprise.
All good.
Okay, the procedural motion reads, to change the plenary agenda and shift agenda point, the adoption of the CCC report as the second to last agenda point. IFMSA Executive Board, would you like to explain?
So that the added explanation was already shared, so that if there are any CCC interpretations that need to be added from the AOB section of today's agenda are added in the CCC final report. Thank you.
So be it. Do we have a seconder for this motion? Raise your hand. AEM Burkina Faso. AEM Burkina Faso would like to second this motion as indicated in the chat and just confirmed by me verbally. Since it's a procedural motion and I do not consider it as important as suspending paragraphs, we would proceed with the shorter version. Do we have any direct negatives against this procedural motion? Is anybody against this procedural motion? Raise your hand now. Again, repeating, if nobody is against, then it would have passed by 2/3 majority with all present animals with voting rights in favor. Is anybody against this motion? Okay, procedural motion passes by 2/3 majority with
71 animals.
Sure, 71 animals in favor. Very good. In that case, agenda point 56 has been moved as agenda point 58. Therefore, we move forward to the new agenda point 56, which is closing ceremony. IFMSA team officials, you have the floor.
This will be done after the closing of the plenary, IFMSA President.
Thank you, IFMSA President. Therefore, we're going to proceed to the new agenda point 57, any other business. We have received several motions in this that fulfill the criteria for this topic. We have received a request by BVMD Germany for opening a speaker's list. BVMD, okay, at the end, very good. So in that case, we're opening with motion number sorry, please change the number. Right now, this is 94. So, motion number 94. To close the Task Force on Gender Empowerment and Representation from the 2019-2020 term, tabled by the IFMSA EB. Executive Board, would you like to explain?
Yes, so we discussed this as already a task force related to similar topic with different objectives and different composition has been adopted for 2021 term yesterday. It's important that this task force is closed as this task force for the 2019 and 2020 term is closed, and the timeline of this task force has already ended by AM 2020. So yeah, that's it. Explanation from our
end. FMSA VPA. Do we have a seconder for this motion? Mr. Rwanda.
We would like to second this motion.
Who are you?
Serge Messaranda.
Thank you, Mr. Rwanda. Do we have any proposed amendments? Any direct negatives? Motion passes, Nemo Contra. I would like to thank the task force for their work during the past 1 year. Your work is highly appreciated. We're moving forward to a motion number 95, not 96, we changed it, to adopt the following mandate: to mandate the Supervising Council to further develop the SUPCO reports submitted for General Assembly meetings and accordingly update the Supervising Council internal operating guidelines tabled by the IFMSA Executive Board. EB, would you like to speak?
Yeah, so we have already in this mandate given our reasoning why we would like to have this particular mandate. After this, this was shared with NMOs and SUPCO. After that, we received a detailed reply from SUPCO, to which yesterday after the plenary, EB has again sent a detailed clarification of each point that SUPCO has raised. Following that, there has been another email by the SUPCO just today morning related to the alternative motions that they would like to propose in this regard. So we would like to point out a few things. Okay. In addition, our comments right now are as to why we would like to go with the current mandate and not the alternative motion. So we as executive board feel that the purpose of mandate that we have tabled changes with the alternative motion that Supervisory Council has put forth. In relations, we have already pointed out the issues through our EB mandate report, and we and even NMOs have pointed out issues related to the current format of SUPCO reports in March meeting 2020 and August meeting 20. We feel that if alternative motion is given precedence, there would be further confusion and healthy spirit and safe spirit of collecting inputs from different IFMSA bodies, including previous officials who have multiple times internally raised concerns related to the format of the SUPCO report would go away. And we also feel the points in the alternative motion do not have a system of NMOs to give ideas or share perceptions and give constructive feedback. Nowhere in our mandate have we put up any points related to SUPCO investigation. We think that this is a completely different point, which further supervisory council has to look into and consult NMOs independently. And this mandate is nowhere related to pointers related to SUPCO investigation. In addition, in this alternative motion, SUPCO has also added points related to monthly report, and we would like to highlight our concerns have been related to SUPCO report submitted for the General Assembly. And with these points mentioned, I would finally like to say that on behalf of Executive Board, that I would finally like to say that this would be mandate largely worked upon by Supervisory Council 2021, and what were the reviews of this elected Supervisory Council members in this particular regards. If anything,
okay, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Okay, VPA, your time is elapsed. Thank you very much. I'm opening a speakers list. If anybody would like to be heard on this topic, please raise your hand. We have IFMSA SUPCO member Hannah. Anybody else? Okay, Hannah, you have the floor.
Thank you. This is Hannah from SUPCO. Dear NMOs, as you have probably seen in the NMO server, after the discussion yesterday and the postponement of the voting for the mandates directed towards the SUPCO, we have sent you a proposal for alternative mandates. After carefully reviewing the mandates as proposed by the EB, we have noted that some of the processes mentioned can be done in a simpler, more outcome-oriented way, without diminishing the end goal. The reason why we wanted to propose our own version is to have mandates that are more clearly defined in their goals and more easily understood, with keeping the reasoning behind the mandate. We believe that the original mandates proposed do not cover the entire topic of accountability in the first mandate, and both include some repetitive processes that were already part of our mode of action anyway. These also potentially include conflicts of interest, which is something we want to minimize, the alternative mandates proposed include most of the actions as proposed in original mandates while fostering and even expanding the outcomes. We would also like to know that no concerns were raised regarding SEPCO report until this term. Lastly, we would like to mention that the Supervising Council does not have voting rights, which means that in order for the alternative mandates to be brought forward, an NMO will need to direct negative the current proposal. We once again apologize for the proximity of sharing the proposals to the plenary session. We hope you understand that this is only due to our commitment to ensure that the final outcome will truly be meaningful towards the perceived reasoning behind these mandates. If questions remain, please feel free to raise them now.
Thank you, IFMSA SEPCO member. We're extending the speakers list. First, we have Anne in Portugal, then IFMSA VPA, then IFMSA President. Anybody else who would like to be heard? Anne in Portugal, we have the floor.
Inês, Anne in Portugal. So firstly, we did not have much time to analyze both proposals and compare, but either way, after trying to have a brief analysis, we do think that the SEPCO proposal suits us best and that the process and it is more clearly goal orientated. However, we would like to propose an amendment to SEPCO's mandate because we do agree that it is important to consult IFMSA team of officials. And yeah, and now I have a question and I would like you to clarify me about how it go, like the voting itself and the process of voting. Thank you.
And in Portugal, you cannot propose amendments to alternative motions.
Okay, thank you.
However, there is the possibility when I ask for amendments that you propose something completely different than what was already proposed. You have that option. So next we have IFMSA VPA, you have the floor.
Yes, I'll first give floor to Nebosha and then add my concluding remarks on Nebosha.
All right, thank you once again for raising the concerns. I have to disagree with part of the statements regarding past concerns and I'm bound by NDAs and I cannot speak about them, but there were concerns raised before regarding past SEPCO reports. This mandate does not come lightly and we understand that it has a lot of implications on the work. We've heard many stories before about the accountability of SEPCO and we've heard much about it. We believe that the NMO report, although it is simple to outline, simple to write in the mandate, will not provide concrete actions for the NMOs, will not provide concrete actions for the SEPCO in regards to what to do. And the NMO report is an already very elaborate, very long document, which might not highlight the importance of this subject. So we don't believe that tying everything up to NMO report, etc., is going to be good. As well as I would like to add that mandates guide our work. Mandate by the General Assembly is not a fully binding request. You are, as a body that is mandated, allowed to also explain the reasons why you could not achieve some of the things. Maybe they weren't clear. Maybe in your work you disagreed with it. Maybe you thought something else. And I would like once again like to highlight that this is the SEPCO elect that is supposed to be working on this, not the current SEPCO. And we have not heard from the SEPCO elect. Which can be problematic in this way, and we're sorry about that.
And to add, we have already mentioned regarding the clarity of the points written about the objectives written in the mandate. Currently, we have just written the primary objectives, and we have written yesterday in our email that further action points for these objectives need to be charted upon by the Supervisory Council 2021, who would be working on this or in the current timeline. And then there should also be there should be an input process with the EB and TO in regards to the action points. And this has been done multiple times when previous mandates have been discussed. So we find that the point that the objectives have been criticized for the specificity is incorrect in this particular regards. Thank you.
Thank you, IFMSA VPA. We're extending the speakers list one last time, and I would also give the floor to the IFMSA Supervising Council elect any of the four members if they would like to speak on this topic. So if you would like to speak as part of the last speakers list, raise your hand now. SEPCO member Hannah, then VPA Sania, you have the floor.
Hi, so I Hannah from SEPCO. We really don't want to get into a long discussion regarding this because we believe this is definitely something that is up to the animals to decide. But we just would like to mention that according to our experience in gathering the data from the side of the animals, whenever it was done outside of the animal report, there was not representative data there. So less than half of the animals usually reply, and even that is a lot. And this is why we believe that we cannot really have a way forward with such little data that we usually get when we do any sort of surveys or any sort of research inside the IFMSA. Thank you.
Thank you, VPA, you have the floor as the last speaker of the speakers.
Yeah, and we have already highlighted this in methodologies and both our emails that we have requested for both formal and informal consulting mechanisms, formal being NMO reports and informal being other sort of surveys. We have observed in past entire year that whenever separate surveys are conducted with specific questions with a lot of responsibility, you can get qualitative responses from the NMO, but NMO report gives you quantitative, and thus having both of these methodologies is important, and not just NMO reports, to have balanced data in terms of qualitative and quantitative analysis. And further, I would like to just highlight what we have said as executive board. We feel that the alternative motion completely derails the point and redirects it into the points that we would not like this mandate to go into, that is subco investigation, which we feel is a completely different point, a subco monthly reports, which is not a all related to the mandates that we have tabled, and we would like to highlight that this is against the original intention of the mandate and the reasoning that we have proposed the same for. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, VPA. Plenary Secretary Mohammed, you have the floor.
Yes, I would just like to ask for 1 minute technical break. I need to discuss something with you before we proceed with this motion. So 1 minute.
Okay. Okay, everyone, I would just like to give you a heads up that I would have to leave in about 8 minutes, and I would hand over the chairing to the vice chairperson. So just heads up on that. And I would also like to remind everyone, please make sure that your statements have been sent to Plenary Secretary and secretary-team@ifmsa.org. Okay, Plenary Secretary, we can proceed. Please share your screen. Again, we're at motion number 95, mandate submitted by IFMSA Executive Board. The mandate is addressing the Supervising Council. It was just discussed, therefore we're going to proceed. Do we have a seconder for this motion? I ask again, do we have a seconder for this motion? Okay, due to the fact that we have failed to find IFMSA Japan, IMCC Denmark. Okay, what's happening? You want to speak or not? IFMSA Japan and IMCC Denmark, I'm going to give you the floor. If you do not wish to speak, say so. If you do, stop playing. Okay, Denmark, IMCC, you would like to second, is that correct? Okay, IMCC Denmark confirms that they would like to second this motion. Do you have any proposed amendments? Raise your hand. And direct negatives? IFMSA Poland.
This is Benjamin from IFMSA Poland, who would like to vote on the alternative motion.
Okay, do we have any? Sure, IFMSA Poland. Do we have any alternative motions? Raise your hand.
Should we say it?
Yes. Raise your hand.
Yes, Hannah, raise your hand. Yes, I think it's supervising council member Hannah, you have the floor.
Yes, we have sent an alternative motion both to the plenary secretary and the NMOs on the NMO server. Do you want
Could you please give us the gist, not the whole thing, just the gist of it. What is alternative to it, to its nature?
Okay, the alternative motion is because it is a more concrete measure of the accountability of the SUPCO and to review the SUPCO reporting procedures, which includes the consultations with the NMOs regarding the GA report, regarding the SUPCO GA report through the NMO report. Additionally, the NMOs will know the questions that are going to be asked in the NMO report. We will also review the potential bylaw change proposals regarding the investigation on the SUPCO members and propose it as a bylaw change proposal for the AM 2021. And additionally, we will update our internal operating guidelines for the AM 2021 according to the new version of the SUPCO GA report.
Thank you, FMC Supervising Council. Unless you have a point of order, lower your hand, VPA. Only a point of order is currently open to question. Okay, very good. Now I ask, do we have a supporter, a seconder for this alternative motion? Raise your hand. IFMSA Kurdistan. Kurdistan, you're not a full member. You cannot second motions. Okay, do we have a seconder for this motion? Turkmenistan, Turkey.
We want to second this motion, Turkmenistan, Turkey.
Thank you, Turkey. Now that we have found a seconder for the alternative motion, I'm going to open a speakers list. If you would like to be heard on this topic, again, we have an original motion submitted by the IFMSA Executive Board and seconded by IMCC Denmark. We also have an alternative motion proposed by the IFMSA Supervising Council and seconded by Turkmenistan, Turkey. If you wish to be heard on the debate on these two motions, raise your hand now. And this is going to be the only speakers list. I'm not extending it. Is that clear? IFMSA VPA, you have the floor.
Thank you. We would like to reiterate some points. First being, this is not in the spirit of the original motion for the mandate that we have proposed. It is redirecting and distracting in terms of a supervisory council investigation and in terms of SUPCO monthly reports, which have not been in our original mandate at all. The next thing is this mandate has also, the alternative motion also takes away the important point there wherein we would like to have a CCC for the March meeting 21 to overlook the structure of Supervisory Council report. We think having a neutral body like the CCC is very important so that further confusions and expectation realities from different IFMSA bodies, mainly NMOs, IFMSA EB, IFMSA TO, Supervising Council, and conflicts with the same in regards to the structure of the SUPCO report is avoided. This point has been taken out. Additionally, this alternative motion invalidates the internal concerns that team of officials since past two terms have been raising, 2018-19 and 2019-20 have been consistently raising in related to the SUPCO report. And finally, the alternative motion also takes away the possibility of having more qualitative responses collected from the NMOs from modality apart from NMO report. NMO report is important and it's responsible for having quantitative responses like the increased number of responses from multiple NMOs more than just 50% through NMO report, and our original mandate already had this modality of collecting responses through NMO report and was much more representative of having both qualitative and quantitative responses. That's it from
IFMSA VPA. We have received a point of order by IFMSA Poland. Poland, you have the floor.
Okay, so according to the debate maze, after the seconder is found, there should be a vote directly. The second speaker's list should be opened before the chair asks for the seconder, at least according to what I have seen.
This is my decision at this point. Of course, that is generally the rule. However, due to the fact that we do have a an alternative motion that has to be explained and decided to open the speakers list afterwards. Do you have an issue with that, IFMSA Poland?
No, but at least
so
different is
if you're since you're opening a point of order, would you like to go back to the start of the motion? Because that's your only option right now. If you're raising a point of order stating that the procedure was not followed, then we have to go back to the start of the motion. Is that what you're suggesting right now?
No, according to me, there should be not the speaker list right now. There should be we should go directly to vote between the original motion and the alternative motion.
Okay, in that case, your option was to submit a procedural motion to move forward directly to a vote. However, now that we're done with the debate, we're going to move forward to the vote. So you have two motions, the original motion as submitted by IFMSA EB and seconded by IMCC Denmark. We also have an alternative motion proposed by the IFMSA Supervising Council and seconded by Turkmenistan Turkey. You have the choice to vote in either one of the two or to abstain, or sorry, to vote against both.
Against both.
By chairperson, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to give over the floor to the vice chairperson, including to move forward, as I have to leave for work. So thank you, everyone, from my side. Yazid, you have the floor.
Thank you, Peter, for all your efforts. Bye-bye. Okay, so we're moving forward. Plenary 8, motion number 95, mandate the Supervising Council to further develop the SEPCO report. We have four options: in favor of the original, in favor of the alternative, against both, or abstain. Please vote now. You have 1 minute. Okay, 20 more seconds. The voting is closed now. Okay, we have the results. So we have 68 animals who have voted, 17 in favor of the original, 37 in favor of the alternative, 0 against both, and 14 abstentions. Again, 17 in favor of the original, 37 in favor of the alternative, 0 against both, and 14 abstentions. The alternative motion passes with relative majority. Thank you, Plenary Secretary. Can we move forward to the next motion? Motion 96, to adopt the following mandate the Supervising Council to clarify the leadership structure and the word post, what post means in IFMSA. Proposed by IFMSA Executive Board. IFMSA EB, would you like to explain?
Yes, just give me a minute.
There's a point of order from SEPCO.
Okay, point of order, SEPCO. Hannah or Sunny, one of you, please go ahead.
So as it is written in the bylaws, the mandate should go through the two-thirds majority. So as far as it was done, it should be first voted on whether to vote on a original motion or the alternative motion, and then afterwards to have a vote.
Yes,
for the two-thirds majority.
That is correct. Thank you, Supervising Council, for that point of order. Even though I should have learned from my mistake yesterday because I read the bylaws regarding it. Can we go back to motion number 95? Okay, so we have no motion actually achieved the two-thirds majority. So we're going now to a vote. Do you mean that, Hannah, Supervising Council, to go to a vote on the alternative motion to achieve the two-thirds majority?
Yeah, so it's just voted. So you need to gain a relative majority for the for which one of the motions should be put forward and then voted,
yes,
by the two-thirds majority to confirm. by the GA.
Okay. Okay, so we're going to vote on the alternative motion to gain two-thirds majority. Point of order by NM France, August.
August and NM France, since they gained the two-thirds relative majority, isn't that superfluous to go through the additional vote since it's basically two-thirds majority since the abstentions do not count and 37 versus 17 is two-thirds majority?
I cannot give you an answer. I would like to ask the CCC regarding that.
Hello,
CCC.
Yes, thank you for the subcode. We were just searching for the bylaw, but they're right. After passing the relative majority, the motion needs another vote to reach and to pass with two-thirds majority. So even if there is a two-thirds majority in this relative vote, this is a relative majority for alternative motions. So it needs another vote to reach two-thirds majority to pass. Are we clear?
Okay, August, are you fine with that? You just had your answer.
August and France, I guess so, but I'd say it's not necessary, but yeah, however.
Okay, thank you. Okay then, so we're going now to a vote on the motion number 95, which is the alternative one, so we can move forward to it, mandating the Supervising Council to further develop the SEPCO report. And just to remind everyone, this is the alternative motion that was sent by the Supervising Council because it has just passed with relative majority. So we're going to have two-thirds majority regarding it in order for it to become an official mandate. And you have three options: in favor, against, or abstain. Please vote now. You have 1 minute. Okay, we have 20 more seconds. And the voting is closed now. Okay, we have the results. Secretary, you ready? Yes. So it is ready. Okay, we have 52 in favor, 1 against, and 12 abstentions. 52 in favor, 1 against, and 12 abstentions. Motion passes with two-thirds majority. Okay, Austria, you raised your hand. Do we have a point of order? Point of order, IFMSA Austria. Go ahead.
Thank you, IFMSA Austria, and I'm sorry to say it now, and I don't know if it makes any difference, but is it correct that there was an option for against both when we voted for the amendment versus the original one? And I don't know if it makes any difference at all because no one voted for it, but should there?
There was an option when we had the alternative motion versus the original. There was an option for against both and an option for abstentions, but no one voted against both. We had zero votes regarding against both.
So that's fine then, because we were wondering whether it should have been included or not.
It was, but no one voted for that option.
But it was correct to include it?
Yes, I can show you my screen. Secretary, can you please not share your screen because I want to open it. Okay, can you see my screen now? So this is the motion, the first one that we voted with the alternative versus the original. As you can see the results, we had in favor of the original, in favor of the alternative, against both, which had zero votes, no one voted for it, and 14 abstentions. So we had four options.
Sorry, can I reply? Thank you for showing that and for clarifying it, but that was not really our point. We were just wondering whether it was correct to include the option at all.
It is. You can vote against both, yes.
Right, thank you.
Okay, thank you. I'm South Austria. Plenary Secretary, can you please share your screen again? Thank you. Okay, so moving forward to motion number 96 to adopt the following mandate, to mandate the Supervising Council to clarify the leadership structure and post in IFMSA. IMSA Austria, if you have a point of information, say it, unless if not, please lower your hand. Okay, thank you. IFMSA Executive Board, would you like to explain?
Yes, we have already shared clarification yesterday on NMO server, but after receiving alternative motion, we would like to again highlight that there is difference of interpretations between IFMSA body in past, which and you have clearly seen it in the EB mandate report and the SUPCO report for August meeting 2020. This not only hindered the administration and the timeline for the plenary and plenary preparation this August meeting, and created contrast in selection process in between the calls and a lot of confusion in this regard. We would like to highlight that the point related to posts has been there and in long work in IFMSA strategy, but that was in regards of overlapping between the working arenas in different posts. And now that we are highlighting the levels of posts in IFMSA in this regards, and therein we find it problematic that SUPCO wants to finalize this mandate by MM21 when there has been past records that this thing takes often a lot longer, and previous work on this has taken approximately about 3 years. So we would like to highlight that timeline, shifting timeline from AM21 to MM21 is not just harmful for the quality of work done that can be done in this regards, but it can also create a lot of similar administrative problems with difference of interpretation in midge of the term for the next IFMSA term of 2021, as this mandate would be finalized by MM21, which is exactly in middle of the term. Further, we would also like to highlight that the current interpretations are done by a group of executive council that is in office right now, and majority of the work done would be by supervisory council elect, and the current interpretations are not representative of what interpretations the next supervisory council can have in this regards. Thus, taking this into point, we need to give a benefit of doubt that interpretations would be different, and we need to give space for having consistency in interpretations. Again, we would like to point out that alternative motion proposed by the Supervisory Council is not in the effect of the intention of mandate that we would like to have and the exact reason why we proposed it. It from our end.
Thank you, VPA. I'm going to open a speakers list. So who would like to speak in regards of this motion? Please raise your hand now. I guess no one. Okay, Hannah. Raise your hand now if you would like to speak. Okay, we have IFMSA Supervising Council, Hannah Luchev, and NM Portugal. IFMSA SUPCO, you can go, Hannah.
Hi, thank you, Hannah from SUPCO. So we would just like to say that we are also proposing an alternative motion, which requires a direct negative for it to be put forward. And we will make, I think that we explained properly in the previous one, so we would not like to repeat ourselves. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, SUPCO. And in Portugal?
Inês and I'm Portugal. So with regards to these two specific motions, we would like to fully support the executive board mandate, because we believe that in this case it addresses what we really need now. And yeah.
Okay, thank you, and in Portugal. Okay, I guess that we had enough explanation regarding that. Can you please go back to the motion, secretary? Okay, so the mandate is proposed by IFMSA Executive Board. Do we have a seconder? And in Portugal.
We would like to second this motion.
And who are you?
Inês, I am Portugal.
Thank you, and in Portugal. Yeah. Do we have any amendments? Any direct negatives? Bulgaria, AMSB. Bulgaria, would you like to explain? Okay, so they explained in writing, AMS Bulgaria has a direct negative without an explanation. Do we have an alternative motion? I'm going to say SUPCO, Hannah.
Yes, this is Hannah from SUPCO. Oh, sorry. So the SUPCO has sent an alternative motion through the NMO server. So in short, we agree that there have been inconsistencies in IFMSA regarding the interpretation of the bylaw paragraphs regarding this. Nevertheless, the SUPCO has reviewed those bylaw paragraphs on multiple times, and we believe that the best way forward is just to propose a bylaw change proposal which will clarify it once for all, and just to ensure that there is no more inconsistencies regarding the interpretation, which are mostly related to the plenary team and the task force members regarding their post and the position in IFMSA. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, SUPCO. So as per the bylaws, I'm going to open a speakers list. If you would like to speak regarding the alternative or the original motion, please raise your hand now. IFMSA VPA Sania, who else? Wait. Okay, I guess no one would like to speak regarding that. IFMSA VPA, you have the floor.
Thank you so much. We would again like to reiterate that the alternative motion is not in line and with the spirit of the original motion of the mandate, and this changes the purpose, essence, and our intentions. As well, we would also like to highlight the timeline that has been proposed in alternative motion does not, in our opinion, give scope for thorough work in the Federation as to what conflicts with previous interpretations have been. This entire concept of post in IFMSA has to be looked into the line with the work that has been done in past 3 years in regards to the overlap of work in different posts in IFMSA and also different level of posts and which can be held simultaneously or which cannot be held in simultaneously. In our strong opinion, we do not think that such thorough detailed work can be done hurriedly until March meeting 2021, continuing the interpretations which have been problematic in first place in regards to August meeting 2020. And this needs a bit more detailed work, which we have highlighted in our objectives and for which we have proposed the timeline of August meeting 2021. Also, in addition, to take care that this does not affect in mid of the term for the next term, and it's implemented from the year after the next. That is from 2021 and 2022, altogether in fresh start. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, IFMSA VPA. I guess no one else would like to speak. Then we will proceed to a vote. We'll proceed to a seconder, to finding a seconder. Okay, so we have an alternative motion by the Supervising Council. Do we have any seconder? Kenya. Msaki Kenya.
This is Yasser Hamza, Msaki Kenya. We would like to second this motion.
Okay, thank you, Kenya. We have a seconder. Now we're going to a vote. So plenary number 8, motion number 96, mandate for the Supervising Council to clarify the leadership structure and post in IFMSA. You have 4 options: in favor of the original motion proposed by IFMSA EB, in favor of the alternative motion proposed by the IFMSA Supervising Council, against both, or abstain. Please vote now. Any more seconds? And the voting is closed now. Okay, so we have 15 in favor of the original, 38 in favor of the alternative, 2 against both, and 6 abstentions. Again, 15 in favor of the original, 38 in favor of the alternative, 2 against both, and 6 abstentions. The alternative motion passes with the relative majority, and now we're going for a vote to achieve 2/3 majority regarding that motion. I'm just preparing it real quick. Okay, so now we're going to vote on the mandate for the Supervising Council, the alternative motion that was proposed and passed by relative majority by the Supervising Council to achieve 2/3 majority, which is required by the bylaws for mandates in IFMSA. So you have 3 options: in favor, against, or abstentions. Please vote now. You have 1 minute. Twenty more seconds. And the voting is closed. Okay, we have 47 in favor, 7 against, and 9 abstentions. 47 in favor, 7 against, and 9 abstentions. Motion passes by 2/3 majority. Okay, now we're going back to the agenda item number 57. This should be, yes. Adoption of the final CCC report. So motion number 97, adoption of the final report of the Constitutional Credential Committee for the August meeting 2020, proposed by IFMSA Executive Board. IFMSA EB, would you like to explain?
No, we would not like to explain anything extra. Thank you.
Okay, before I move on to a seconder, IFMSA CCC, would you like, and you know what? I'll give the CCC 1 more minute until they fix the report to add the decisions that have been given here. Do we have a seconder? PMSA Palestine.
Hello, IFMSA CCC, Michelle.
Wait, Michelle, we have a seconder. PMSA Palestine, can you confirm you want to second this motion, verbally or on chat?
We would like to second it. PMSA Palestine here. We would like to second the motion.
Thank you, Palestine. Okay, IFMSA CCC, you have the floor.
Hello, Michelle from CCC. Can someone just, because we would like to explain the report, if some NMOs have any concerns, like we said the last time at the present session, that we will explain the report today. Really shortly, briefly, quickly, if it's possible, Vice Chair?
Yes, it is.
Okay, thank you very much.
So, okay, so you would, Angelo, CCC member, would you like to share your screen? So, Saad, can you please make him a host, a co-host?
You can share the screen without being co-host, so.
Okay, Angelo, you can go ahead, share your screen.
Okay, so
just to make sure that everyone understands what they vote. They will vote for this report, but with included in that report also the two mandates that were adopted just before a few minutes, and the closing of the task force, and a corrected mistake that we had in this report in the section of sending committee directors' candidatures under SCOMI director, in the candidature of Ali Chanawi from IFMSA Morocco. In the result, we had written that Ali Chanawi was elected as SCOPI director. We had corrected as SCOMI director. We are sorry, and we would like to thank the two NMOs that didn't hesitate to reach us. So yes, after that said, we can start. Defo?
Okay, hi NMOs. As you know, the CCC is composed by 5 members, Angelo, Gonzalo, Janine, Leib, and Michel. And we're going to give you a brief review of the final report, as we discussed in the president sessions, but we consider that we have to do it before the adoption of the report. As you know, we received one candidature for the next August meeting. It was invalid, but after a procedural motion to overrule the decision of the CCC, the candidature became valid, and then IFMSA Panama was elected to host the next August meeting. We did not receive program proposals or executive board candidatures. In the section of team of official candidatures, all the candidatures were valid. And in the report, you can find all the results of the elections for every position. Okay, as Michel said, we made a mistake here. In the report that we have sent to you, we wrote the SCOPI director, but we have changed it to SCOMI director. You can see that we add all the results in every position. Then we have the supervising council candidatures for the term 2019-2021. We only received one candidature. It was invalid due to these three paragraph, due to these bylaws and constitution violations. Then we have for the term 2020-2022. We have that all the four candidates were valid and all the four were elected for supervising council. You can find the results. And then we have the membership status change candidatures. We received three applications for membership status upgrade. The three were invalid, but after a procedural motion to suspend bylaws annex 2, 2.13 until the end of TGA, the three became valid, NOHSS Ivory Coast, PMSA Palestine, and SMMAMS Malaysia, and they were elected as full members. Then we have the application for candidate membership status. We received 5 candidatures, 3 of them were invalid, but after a procedural motion to suspend bylaws annex 2, 2.13 and annex 2, 2.14 H and B, all the 5 candidates became valid. And UBMSA Botswana, AEMB Benin, SOFMSA Somaliland, LMSA Liberia, and IFMSA BH of Bahrain were elected candidate members in Plenary 5. Then we received 31 bylaw change proposals. 28 were valid and 28 passed and were adopted by the plenary. You can find also if the BCPs were amendment and who amend the BCPs. Then we have the MOUs. 2 of the 3 MOUs were invalid, but after a procedural motion to overrule the decision of the CCC, the MOU with IBSA and IPSF became valid, and then they were adopted by the plenary. Michel, it's your turn.
Okay, so next we proceed with the sponsorship agreement proposals. We have received 2. both invalid. We think that we already explained and we had a conversation with the EB and the animals. So yes, we had also had informal vote that he has taken for both, and we had noted it. So policy proposals, I don't know how many they were, but all of them were valid, if I'm not wrong, and all of them passed. Few of them were, yes, like you can see, amended. So we also wrote the amendments. Thank you, Tarek, 19. We also wrote who amended. We can pursue the task force reports, valid and adopted as well. Official General Assembly GA reports, GA reports from team officials. Yes, all of them valid and all of them passed. Subco report, I'm sorry. Subco report valid and adopted in plenary 2 NEMO Contra. Commitments report 1 received. Adopted by simple majority in plenary 2 as well. General Assembly meetings, financial reports. Tanzania amended their report and it was adopted by NEMO Contra in plenary 7. So they, TAMSA Tanzania, gained voting right in plenary 7. That means yesterday. Quebec also amended their version in accordance with the IFMSA Constitution bylaws, and their report was adopted yesterday. Motion to adopt the report was submitted after the deadline for FMS Taiwan, and their financial report was not adopted. Therefore, FMS Taiwan lost their voting right yesterday, according to Annex 6.1.46. Other submissions. We got the submission for program annual impact report. It was adopted. Global priorities report for the term 2020 to 2021 also adopted. Financial reports, they were not adopted for IFMSA, unfortunately. And other decision made during the General Assembly, you can find there the financial committee report that was adopted yesterday as well. Reports from the CCC, the preliminary report adopted in plenary 2, and the final one, we'll add it in our amended version if adopted. We'll add the result from the vote. Changes in task force status. Also, all of them are here. Do we have the last one closed? Yeah, I think, yeah. Yeah, we got it today. Thank you. Okay, we can continue with changes in program status. No one, bylaw suspensions. We explain the bylaw suspensions and when they occur until when. This is it. Mandates as well. I think that we have even added the last two that just passed before this motion was tabled. Yes. Other motions as well are here. You can see the other motions that were adopted, passed, or failed in different plenaries during this General Assembly meeting. And this is pretty much it, I think. Interpretation. Ah, yes, you have also our interpretation and decisions. Few of them, not all of them, but few, those ones that we judged necessary to be explained. Changes in animal membership status as well. And you have the voting rights down there. Risk of changes in membership status, yes. You have the voting rights per plenaries during all 8 plenaries. And you also have the voting rights per animal at the end, why and how. This is it. I think we are done. Did I miss something, Tefo?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, just something small. Gonzalo from CCC. In the part of the NMOs at risk of losing, at risk of being suspended, the only change is that in the at risk of being suspended because of 2.53. Now Mali and Tajikistan are no longer in the list. So that was the only change from the last report.
From the preliminary, you mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, thank you, CCC. Just prepare your amendments because for the sake of minutes, you're going to repeat them in the motion. Plenary Secretary, can you open the motion again? Okay, thank you, Mamdouh. So again, motion number 97 to adopt the final report of the Constitutional Credential Committee proposed by FMSA Executive Board and seconded by PMSA Palestine. Any amendments? IFMSA CCC, Michelle.
Yeah. So we get the amendment. We amend under Standing Committee Director's candidatures, under SCOMI Director, under the candidate Ali Chanawi.
Yes,
I'm waiting for the. Yeah, I'm waiting for the secretary. Under SCOMI Directors, yes, I'm sure. Yep, as current directors, Ali Chanawi was elected as SCOMI and not SCOPI director. The next one will be the closing of the task force that happened today, a few motions ago. Mm-hmm. And the two mandates that also happened to be adopted by two-third majority before a few motions, and the last one.
Okay, so the two mandates of the Supervising Council?
Yes. I think that therefore write them down.
What about Gonzalo's statement at the end of it?
No, this is not amended. This is from the plenary, from the preliminary report. The last report had already changed that. I mean,
okay, good.
Yes, so no changes in there.
Okay, so these are all the amendments, I presume. Okay, does the proposer accept the amendment? IFMSA Executive Board.
Yes.
And who are you?
Sanya, IFMSA VPA. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can. Okay, does the seconder accept the amendment? PMSA Palestine.
U3 PMSA Palestine, we accept the amendment.
Okay, the amendment is incorporated with the original motion. Do we have any further amendments? CCC, please lower your hand unless you have another amendment. Okay, do we have any direct negatives? Any direct negative? Motion passes nemo contra. Thank you, CCC, for all your hard work. I presume you were going to send the amended version on the NMO server after the plenary when it's finished.
Yes, as soon as possible, we'll send the amended version, yeah.
Okay, thank you, CCC. Moving on to the last agenda item, number 56, closing ceremony. 58, okay, thank you, 58. I'm going to open a speaker's list before we move forward to the motion until the EB sends the procedural motion to adjourn. Just a reminder for them to send it. Who would like to be on the speakers list? Please raise your hand. Plenary Secretary, can you please make a new slide for it? We have quite a number. Okay, we have Azerbaijan. I'm just gonna wait. Can you please wait until I put down all the NMOs I'd like to speak. Yes. Okay. Okay, we have Azerbaijan, LIMSIC Lebanon, IFMSA Morocco, Algeria, Lusouk, IFMSA Quebec, IFMSA Brazil, BVMD Germany, IFMSA Subco, IFMSA RD Americas, and finally IFMSA President. Okay, I guess we can start. IFMSA Azerbaijan, sorry, you have the floor.
Can yes. I request to speak first with this first statement, and then we can proceed with the rest?
Okay, Azerbaijan, do you accept that?
Yes, I accept that.
It is okay, about the statement. That. It is about the statement of IFMSA Guatemala that was shared earlier, and it will involve 3 points, which is first me speaking on behalf of the TO, then statements from our alumni, and then Majo, RD Americas, will read the statement from IFMSA Guatemala. I hope that's okay. Is that better?
Yes. Okay, IFMSA President, you have the floor.
Dear IFMSA, we are deeply saddened to share the news about one of our former members. Earlier this year, Dr. Rosa Isabel Escamilla Brand suddenly passed away. The IFMSA family of that time was shocked when receiving the news during the first days of this meeting. In IFMSA, she is remembered as co-founder of PAMSA, now known as the Americas region, IFMSA's first regional coordinator for the America of the term 2002-2003, IFMSA vice president for internal affairs of the term 2003-2004, founder and first president of IFMSA Guatemala. Her accomplishments, though, extend far beyond the positions she held in IFMSA. She is remembered by her friends for her unique smile, the inner light that shined and brightened all around her, her wisdom and poise beyond her years, and the generosity of her beautiful spirit. They remember all the joy and success they shared with her on their way of making a difference in the world, and the great times they had welcoming each other in their homes across the world. Our work in IFMSA begins as we learn of this magical community and their desire to make a difference. Throughout that time, we work with people just like ourselves, with the same passion and intensity. The mark we leave is not only in the work that is left behind us, the great structural ideas that stand decades later, but also in the people that cross our paths and the people we affect down the line. The stories of procedures will be soon forgotten. The ones that remain will be of the people that will always have a place in our hearts, no matter where they are. The ones with whom we shared countless hours during our time in IFMSA. We would like to express our condolences to her family, to her friends, and the organization she founded, IFMSA Guatemala. We invited some of the people that knew her from her times in IFMSA to share a little bit more about her, and we will be working with them to honor her memory, possibly through an initiative in the Americas region. Thank you, Rosa, for everything you did, and may your actions long inspire others to pursue their dreams. I will now play a video if I can. Can I share screen?
Yes.
Okay.
Opportunity to address.
Tell me if you.
Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Yes, we can hear it and we can see it.
Perfect. Thank you.
So thank you very much for the opportunity to address the IFMSA August meeting on the passing of our friend, Rosa Isabel Escamilla Brand from Guatemala. Many of us knew her as the mother of regionalization in the Americas, and she was also the first regional coordinator who really brought to life both the idea of regionalization in PAMSA and the region, but also for IFMSA as a whole. But many of you beyond that that significant accomplishments might not know that she was also a wonderful person, full of life, always had a smile and a laugh on her face, and a host par excellence who basically knew how to take care of friends, whether you were with her in her country or whether you were joining the IFMSA family for the first time. And so certainly many of us have many memories, and I myself had the chance to visit Rosa in Guatemala in 2008. I really remember just how we could go from laughter to the depth of really conversations and trying to make the world a better place, just all in the same in the same moment and in the same discussion. And so, you know, her loss is certainly felt throughout the generations of those of us who've gone before her in IFMSA. And many of us are now thinking of ways that we can continue to honor her memory in working with the Federation. So, Francisco, did you have anything that you wanted to add?
Thank you, Lawrence, and thank you once again to the Executive Board for giving us this space to remember our friend. Lothar was actually one of the very first person who helped me to start my life in IFMSA. One of the things I will always remember from her, and I will always be thankful with her. She was the kind of person actually that will be that kind of friend that also would be your mother, your mentor, and would be there to guide you and to be there with you, actually even nagging you when you are misbehaving, you and being there to actually carry you all the way through the process to ensure that the work will be done, but also to celebrate and to enjoy the process of building something as good as a region, as fun as it was actually at the moment, but something so wonderful that even 18 years later have actually flourished to be something as wonderful as it is now. Her loss will be missed for a very long time. And we really hope that all the fruits that her work actually start being shown so far will start even grow even further than actually have shown so far. Emily, you were also a very good friend of Rosa's, and maybe you also would like to say something about her.
Yeah, thank you. So for me, Rosa was a person with a very big heart. She cared deeply about everybody who didn't feel included, everybody who's vulnerable, everybody who maybe found it harder to fit in to IFMSA world. And as that, she was always there, smile, kind, with a belly laugh, that was, and we really feel her loss. So I think that that Rosa is gone from this life, but resting in, I will remember not just what she did, but I will how she made me feel. So really, thank you. Opportunity to talk about her, and you must hug your IFMSA friends a little bit closer because you don't know how long you have them for, and they're so, so precious. Find ways, as Lawrence and Francisco were saying, they're going to find ways to honour Rosa. Maybe some mediano, so on information, but yeah, but for now, just remember.
Okay, that was it from there. And if we can only have Maho read the statement on behalf of IFMSA Guatemala that are not here with us, and 1 minute of silence after their statement. Thank you.
Thank you, IFMSA President.
Hi, everybody. Maho,
go ahead.
Thank you. My name is Maho. I'm RD Americas. And as Navarro stated, I will be reading the statement on behalf of IFMSA Guatemala, who could not join us today. So, dear IFMSA members, the IFMSA Guatemala family regrets the sensitive death of Dr. Rosa Escamilla, Isabel Escamilla, who dedicated a large part of her life as a medical student and professional to the foundation and growth of our association. Words cannot express our gratitude for being that pillar that made everything we have accomplished today possible. She was an IFMSA alumni, vice president of IFMSA, founder of FAMSA, IFMSA Americas region, as its first president and regional coordinator, meeting that took place under a tree, as people often recall. She always inspired us with her humility and leadership. Without her, it would not have been possible for us to return to IFMSA. In March 2013, she presented her candidacy at the GA in Baltimore. From that moment on, she never stopped supporting us young medical students, with many longings, dreams, and contributing to our Guatemala and being the change that we want in the world. As an IFMSA Guatemala alumni stated on the America's Plenary this past Tuesday, she was a woman with a voice who inspired me as a young medical student to pursue my dreams. Though she encountered many tribulations and from some of our conversations, issues with her being an empowered woman, she always told me to keep my head up and keep empowering others. Today, we regret her departure, but her legacy will always remain with us. That's why in our first NGA in 2015, we had the honor to create the Rosa Escamilla Award that is given each year to those who inspire and support us as an association. Her legacy will be with us forever. Thank you for everything, Dr. Escamilla. Best regards, IFMSA Guatemala. And we would like to request a minute of silence to honor her memory.
Thank you, RD Americas, and our sincere condolences to her and her family. Okay, as I believe IFMSA Guatemala would like to speak now, or we don't have them with us. Correct me if I'm wrong, IFMSA President.
Majo read their statement.
Ah, okay, okay. Next on the list, we have Azerbaijan. Azerbaijan, you have the floor.
Dear NMOs, dear IFMSA family, during a time when the world was battling the pandemic in July, we witnessed this escalation of tension between Armenia and Azerbaijan along the state border, resulting in many casualties, destroyed households and farms across several districts, villages of Tovuz, Azerbaijan. The family of one of our delegates personally has suffered from these recent clashes and faced mental and material damages. Most importantly, the area of recent clashes is a strategic region where international pipelines pass through and is located far beyond the occupied region of Azerbaijan. 20% of Azerbaijan, Karabakh, and 77 adjacent regions has been under occupation for almost 30 years. No state or international organization recognizes the occupied territories as a separate entity. At the peak of the conflict is Hojali massacre. Over just a few hours, Armenian military personnel massacred 613 Azerbaijani civilians, 106 women and 63 children among them. To this day, the conflict still remains unresolved and the rights of over 1 million refugees forced out of the region are still violated by their inability to return to their property. Besides that, non-refugees and post-war generation are still trying to overcome the aftermath of the conflict. Since then, Armenia installed an illegitimate regime to sustain the occupation of and forced millions of dollars provided by diaspora into military to maintain its policy of occupation in violation of international law. We're also left to tackle disinformation and opinionated attacks spread online. Therefore, we urge you, the future leaders, to ignore misleading or biased information and refer to reliable sources before making any inferences about conflicts. In the past years, we have observed that our colleagues from IFMSA were unaware of the conflict, and we partially assumed the responsibility for their lack of knowledge on the matter. As the GAs are the platform for medical students to raise their concern towards delicate issues, we felt the need to address this human rights issue in light of the recent clashes and disinformation spread online that could only exacerbate the current state of affairs. We are hopeful that the peace negotiations will reach the signing of the final peace agreement, enabling all the displaced persons to return to their homeland and finally establishing peace within the region. Thank you.
Thank you, FMSA Azerbaijan. Next, we have Lemsik Lebanon. Lemsik Lebanon, you have the floor.
Dear NMOs, dear IFMSA family and friends, We had hoped to be addressing you all with better news at the end of this exceptional online General Assembly. As you've heard in our statement during the plenary on the 5th of August, and as you've probably seen on the news, on the 4th of August, an explosion occurred in Beirut, Lebanon, injuring around 5,000 people, killing more than 150 people, and rendering around 3,100 homeless. At a time where our country is facing an economic collapse and a global pandemic to fight, this crippling event has really affected all parts of Lebanon. It's been a few days since the explosion, but LEMSIC has already mobilized its motivated members to donate blood, volunteer in field wound clinics, and participate in cleaning campaigns. These were just the preliminary efforts that we could do until we had time to develop a plan forward. You might ask, how can one actually move forward when they've lost everything? How can one find the courage to continue their daily lives when living is no longer a guarantee? Well, it took us a couple of days to find the answer. But after seeing the immense support IFMSA has given our members in these times, we now know that the answer lies within unity. Therefore, we are kindly calling on all our IFMSA friends and family to lend a hand and support us in rebuilding our country and our animal. It is in these times we know that we can count on you to help us rise to this occasion. In the next 48 hours, we will be sharing a call for donation with our fellow animals on the server. All donations can be sent to one of both LEMSIC bank accounts, one in US dollars and one in euros. For more accountability and transparency, we kindly ask all of you, our friends, to provide us with receipts of donations via our official email, lemsic-lebanon@ifmsa.org. We'll be sharing with you as well a list detailing how your donations were invested and used within the Lebanese community. We are aware it is unusual for an animal to ask for this form of help, but these are unusual times, and we are refusing to let the Lebanese population fight this on their own. On behalf of all the LEMSIC members and the Lebanese people, I thank you from the bottom of my heart for your warm wishes, your support, and your consideration. And we thank you for any form of assistance you could possibly provide us. Thank you.
Thank you, LEMSIC Lebanon. Next on the speakers list, we have IFMSA Morocco. You have the floor.
Hello, IFMSA Morocco. Can we go after Quebec, please?
Okay, if you want to, that is possible. Then next we have Lusuk, Algeria. You have the floor.
Thank you. Dear animals, first of all, I would like to thank the IFMSA EBTO Plenary team for making this General Assembly possible, and to the animals for their interest and contributions. Thanks to all of the hard work and dedication, we gathered more than 1,000 medical students worldwide in one place, hoping to make change through all the discussions. With these statements, we would like to stress on the current situation that the world is living, which has been tough on each and every one of us, and especially for health workforce. Thousands of doctors, nurses, and cleaning agents have been fighting this pandemic, leaving their children behind for months. Some of them don't even have basic safety equipment. In Algeria, the situation is alarming. Over 80 deaths and 4,000 cases among health workforce since March 2020. Doctors are just exhausted. Seeing their friends and colleagues being tested positive every day led them to the edge of depression and burnout. Today, we would like to express our gratitude and show all our support to WOUTs, not only in Algeria, but all over the world, especially in Lebanon, where they have to deal with both the pandemic and recent explosion. All our thoughts and prayers are with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Algeria. Next, we have IFMSA Quebec. You have the floor.
Thank you. Could we request that IFMC Brazil goes right after us? They will be completing our statement.
Okay, that can
that's happen. Fine. All right, thank you. We deliver this statement on behalf of IFMC Quebec, IFMC Brazil, and CFMS Canada. We want to bring attention to what we believe is both a concern and an opportunity for our federation. A few weeks ago, police brutality events in the United States of America led to the amplification of the Black Lives Matter movement. This movement potentialized an already existing and essential fight for equity, diversity, and inclusion, EDI. Such events are unfortunately not isolated and are a manifestation of deeply rooted systemic discrimination of various forms and injustice, including racism. Systemic discrimination is the microaggressions faced by minority groups on a daily basis. Systemic discrimination is not having inclusion and diversity policies to bridge the gap of unequal access to opportunities. Systemic discrimination is the insensitive, stereotypical jokes made to anyone who does not fit the majority. Systemic discrimination is not having adequate representation of the diversity within the leadership of an organization. Sadly, no organization is immune to it, and that includes our healthcare systems, IFMSA, and its NMOs. Every standing committee in IFMSA should actively work to bring awareness and create safe discussion spaces where members can exchange and imagine solutions to promote equity, diversity, and inclusion within IFMSA and their local student associations. Systemic discrimination happens in every region and has many faces, from BIPOC people suffering institutionalized racism to lack of gender and sexual diversity. No one is free of systemic discrimination. Just like environmental health, EDI needs to be talked about everywhere and all the time. Systemic discrimination is a medical education issue. Systemic discrimination is a sexual health and gender diversity problem. Systemic discrimination is a public health crisis. Systemic discrimination is a rampant obstacle in both research and clinical settings. Systemic discrimination is a human rights disaster. Systemic discrimination is a global health emergency. We cannot justify our silence on this topic by relying on past sporadic and punctual projects that didn't have long-term and sustainable impacts. At the same time, our inaction enables a system that continues inflicting trauma and microaggressions on our fellow health students and our future patients. An intersectional approach to address the interactions between various forms of discrimination is required while recognizing the unique challenges and needs of multiple groups. To ensure inclusive and adapted action, representatives of various minorities must be given the space to raise their voice while counting on the majority as reliable allies. Minorities should not bear the emotional burden alone of fighting systemic discrimination while being the ones suffering from it.
Having strong instance on equity, diversity, and inclusion is the foundation of unified and targeted action. We must be bold. We cannot only speak of cultural competence when active anti-racism and healthcare fight is needed. We cannot merely provide equal opportunities to all when we must build bridges for those facing unfair amounts of barriers. Adequately acknowledge the issues is the paramount to lead actions. However, organizations are criticized for the instances that are not matched by the actions. Standing in solidarity is necessary, but not nearly sufficient to tackle the issue of discrimination that is profoundly anchored in our organizations, societies, and healthcare systems. As such, we must all commit to joining the fight against discrimination and bringing health in the discussion around equity, diversity, and inclusion. We would like to commend the work that has been done by so far by IFMSA, while highlighting the need for further action. Our full specific calls to actions will be shared to all NMOs on the NMO server. If you would like to support this statement, please reach out to us. We would like to conclude with a quote from Ibram X. Kendi that we believe, even though pertains explicitly to racism, is applicable to all forms of discrimination. The only way to undo racism is to consistently identify and describe it, and then dismantle it. Thanks.
Thank you, IFMSA Quebec and Brazil, IFMSA Brazil, for that statement. Next, we have IFMSA Morocco. IFMSA Morocco, you have the floor.
Thank you. IFMSA Morocco, dear IFMSA, we spent our time since the end of the plenary 7 overthinking what happened, discussed, and brought to us during that plenary. Some of us were shocked, others upset, and some sad to see that the realm we were building for almost 17 years now has been affected by supposed violation of the core of the Federation, our values. In this regard, it is our responsibility to follow up and take concrete actions to help to ensure a fair and harmful process and hope for a good recovery. First, vote and a democratic process allegations of IFMSA ODIHL election. We thank IFMSA Lithuania for speaking up and reporting this matter to the GA, and also the IFMSA Executive Board for their reactivity and giving the proper attention to this serious matter. We believe that sharing an anonymous form to collect proof of such behavior is the very first step, And in order to properly fight this together, the involvement of NMOs is required during all the process. We ask the EBN subco to share with NMOs the concrete plan that they intend to follow in order to report on this matter. Second, motion 94, investigate violation of privacy and democratic process by QMSA Qatar president. We want to reiterate what was already said in our previous statement. However, we have some concerns regarding the impact of the conflict that can be generated due to the fact that the investigated person is also an official elect. This can have some serious effect on many aspects, such as the TO elect dynamics and the implication in the decision-making process within the TO elect. The image of our federation, these such allegations are considered harmful in the eyes of our partners, and if externals know that we haven't took any immediate action, this could have tremendous implication on IFMSA relations. Influence on the investigation process as a member of the TO, influence on the ITPC core selection, including core EMR RTTM and also the Standing Committee Regional Assistance. Prepare and head the delegation to EMR Regional Committee, as well as communication with WHO on behalf of IFMSA during the elect period. In order to prevent this, we ask NMOs and the supervising council to support these actions. As the investigation of official elect isn't described in our constitution and bylaw, we suggest that the investigation shall be conducted accordingly to the process of the investigation of an official. Second, apply the bylaw 6.8 of IFMSA constitution and bylaw, stating the supervising council may place an official on probation for a period of time during which their functions may be limited, monitored, or directly supervised by a member of the supervising council. Following this period of probation, the supervising council will further evaluate the individual in the context of the initial investigation. The investigated shall be distant from the work of our federation until the report of the investigation is shared. We request that the RD-elect shall be placed on probation until the end of the investigation. We need to apply a tolerance zero and respect our policies, and we think that probation is a fair and a minimal action that we should take. We ask NMOs to conduct an informal vote so that the supervising council could follow up on this request. We also submitted a procedural motion. You can read it, please.
Yes, let me check. It was submitted, yes. We have a procedural motion. IFMSA secretary, can you please make a slide regarding that? And I'm going to ask the CCC regarding the validity of this motion. Plenary Secretary, can you show us the motion on the screen, or do you need more time? Okay, I'm going to read it in the meantime. So we received a procedural motion from IFMSA Morocco, and it says to instruct the IFMSA Supervising Council to probate from all tasks and responsibilities RDEMR elect Abdallah Tom until the end of the investigation. It is proposed by IFMSA Morocco, and the CCC requested a technical break of 3 minutes until they can decide whether this motion is valid or not. So we're going to take a break.
Can I add an explanation, please?
Yazid, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes, I'm sorry, I lost connection. I'm adding the slide now.
Okay, no problem.
Can I just add something?
Yes, I can say Morocco, go ahead.
Okay, this is to say that even if motion doesn't pass, this is a call that IFMSA should address this topic with great leadership, that we should not tolerate any assimilate allegation to our officials that would represent us in this, that would represent us. This is for the minute, this is for the history that IFMSA does not tolerate this. Thank you.
Thank you, IFMSA Morocco. Okay, CCC, are you ready? IFMSA CCC. Okay, so the CCC should be ready right now. Can I have an answer? IFMSA, raise your hand and unmute yourself. IFMSA CCC, please raise your hand and unmute yourself and give us an answer. Is this motion valid?
Hello, no, Michelle from CCC, no, this motion is not valid because such procedural motion are not part of our constitution and bylaws. And then we would like just to explain the bylaw paragraph 6.8 about the supervising council may place an official on probation. Yes, but the person in question right now is not an official. Yes.
Can you please raise your voice or get the mic?
Yes. It's not, the person is not an official yet. And then at the end of the bylaw, it says, this individual in context of the initial investigation and the subco haven't made initial investigation yet. So yes, these are also two things to clarify about the motion. So, yeah.
Thank you, IFMSA CCC. So this motion is invalid and thus we're not going to have a vote regarding it. Next on the list, can we go back to it? Who's that?
IFMSA Morocco again.
Yes.
Can I just reply to the CCC?
Is that a point of information?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so regarding the bylaw 6.8 that wasn't incorporated in the motion, so your interpretation was not in point because we asked to follow the process of investigating an official to investigate an official elect that was a suggestion to the subco in order to complete their mandate voted yesterday. And as the motion is invalid, can we just have an informal vote on this in order to guide the subco on this matter?
Okay, CC, you would like to reply back to that?
Yes, we would just like to add that the motion fails and is invalid just because of bylaw paragraph 3.62, because this kind of procedural motion is not the procedural motion. This is like the other point, the 6.8, we were just trying to explain if eventual further actions, how they can be part of the solution. So thank you.
Thank you, Michelle. Okay, can everyone lower their hand right now? Because I would like to have an informal vote regarding it. Okay, so if you'd like to proceed for an informal vote, I need to see a significant amount of hands, at least 20 hands. As IFMSA Morocco has proposed, they would like to instruct the supervising council to put the RD elect on probation until the end of the investigation with all their tasks. And this would be an informal vote. It doesn't have, it is not a mandate, and the supervising council can discuss it later on. It's not an informal vote, and it's not going to be an obligatory one. Okay, so if you are in favor of what IFMSA proposed, IFMSA Morocco, raise your hand. If I see a significant amount of hands, I will go for a vote on NEMO vote so we can have a clear answer regarding it. I have about 13 or 14 animals who have raised their hands. I need more. Okay, then we're going to make a motion for NEMO vote to have that. Okay, so before I go to the vote and start it, does anybody would like to speak regarding this matter before we go to the vote? Please, everyone, lower your hands now so I can have... Please, everyone, lower your hand first. Iraq, Paraguay, Costa, Ivory Coast, please lower your hand. Everyone, lower your hand. After I ask a question, you can raise them up again. Okay, thank you. Does anyone would like to speak regarding what IFMSA Morocco is proposing? Raise your hand now. Okay, we have Jordan, IFMSA Joe, Metzko Oman, and Kamsa Cameroon. Does anybody else would like to speak? Kamsa Austria? Okay, I think that this is the speaker's list for now. IFMSA Joe, you have the floor. IFMSA Joe, we cannot hear you.
Thank you so much, Yazid. Dear animals, it's important.
IFMSA Joe. Is it only me that can't hear them, or
no? We can.
Is it a common problem? Okay, IFMSA Joe, we cannot hear you. Jordan, I guess IFMSA Joe doesn't hear us as well. Okay, IFMSA Joe, until you fix your technical problem, I'm going forward to the next on the speaker's list, Metzko Oman. So fix it, and then we get back to you. Metzko Oman, you have the floor.
Thank you, Yazid. So my point is that the investigation is supposed to finish by September, as the previous motion that we took yesterday. And we see that there is no use in probation as he is still an elect, and we still don't know what is the idea of what's going on. And that's all.
Okay, thank you, Metzko Oman. Austria, IMSA Austria.
Thank you. IMSA Austria, we would like to ask two questions actually for clarification. The first one would be in what way exactly this procedure would be different to what would normally happen during an investigation? And the other question would be what kind of consequences we could expect from this informal vote? Thank you.
Okay, I'm directing that question for both the CCC and the Supervising Council, if they can answer that question. After Kamsa Cameroon, you have the floor.
Thank you, dear NMO. As we feel for the victim, we should also assume and believe in the innocence of the RG elected until proven otherwise. And we believe this motion will be affect his reputation, the quality of life, and the future of the generation. I think we should wait until concrete investigation are done before proceeding to the next step. Thank you.
Thank you, Kamsa Cameroon. IFMSA Joe, do we have you back with us? IFMSA Jordan. Okay, for the last time, I'm calling IFMSA Jordan. If they do not respond, I'm going to move forward to IFMSA Subco.
Hi, Yazid. I'm back. Can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
Yazid. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, but there's like a lag. In... Go ahead.
Yazid, خلص, never mind.
Okay, sorry, IFMSA Jordan, but there's a lag in the time between receiving and sending whatever you want to say. So I apologize, fix it, and we might get back if the speaker's list is still open. I'm going to move forward to IFMSA Supervising Council. Supervising Council, you have the floor.
Thank you. This is Hannah from Supervising Council. So we're replying to AMSA Austria's question. So after a brief consultation, we believe that the difference is that we will be monitoring all the communication from the side of the RDEMR and all the actions that he does as an elected official, because that is the only thing that we can do before the 30th of September, before he begins his term.
Okay, thank
is
you.
Enough?
Sorry, can I just ask the second question again, maybe? What the consequences of the informal vote would be? Thank you.
Well, I think that we as a subco have still don't have a very clear plan regarding the how we will follow with the mandate, but we will do whatever the General Assembly wants us to do. Regarding the whatever your informal vote is, we will do our best to fulfill this role.
Okay, thank you, Hannah. IFMSA Joe have sent IFMSA Palestine the statement. So I'm giving the floor to PAMSA Palestine. Go ahead.
Thank you, Yazid. This is a statement from the IFMSA Joe, but they can't say it. During the live due to technical difficulty. Dear NMOs, thank you for your activism on this discussion, as it's very important for us as members to be safe within our NMOs, and this federation allows to clarify that we are in no way discrediting the survivor. However, we find it extremely appalling that CFMS Canada and IFMSA Quebec feel they can come up with a verdict and antagonizing an individual without giving them the benefit of the doubt. What we sympathize with the survivor and condemn all sorts of discriminatory actions. We do not condone pointing fingers and accusations, as they are a form of harassment. We urge the subco to investigate this matter to ensure the safety of our members and advise NMO representatives to think twice about how they bring forth an issue, especially one of such magnitude when they do arise. Adding on, we agree that the timeline of this investigation should be extended, as such matters should be handled. Thank you.
Thank you, PAMSA Palestine and IFMSA Joe, for that statement. I'm going to let you open a speaker's list right now. If you would like to say anything before the final, before the motion goes and we go to the informal voting, please raise your hand now. I guess. Okay, we have IFMSA Quebec and IFMSA Morocco. Okay, anybody else? IFMSA Quebec, you have the floor. Yes, IFMSA President.
Before you continue, I apologize, but earlier today there was a request on bringing down the yesterday's discussion from YouTube and not recording it. So I just want to remind everyone that I said okay. that if you want something that done, it is your request. The EB will not interfere with this.
Okay, I will not. Okay, then IFMSA President, thank you for that. Then I'm going to stop this because that we already have enough discussion regarding that. And I had received a question. I do not understand what's happening, which would be the consequences of this probation. IFMSA Subco, can you answer that question again? What are the consequences of that probation? What would be?
Yes, so when the Supervising Council does an investigation, we usually do not have a final ruling regarding the limiting the work of an official before we have conducted the investigation, we have made our recommendation, whatever that is, unless there is a danger for the IFMSA or unless there's somebody who is violating, I don't know, either the financial or the legal sustainability of IFMSA. What you're asking here now is for us to put a person on a probation before we have done an investigation, which means to put him on a probation in his position as an RD elect, which I believe is clearly outlined in the email from IFMSA Morocco that it entangles the monitoring of the communication with the TO elect and with the EB elect and all his duties as an RD EMR elect, one of them constituting the election of the IT members.
Okay, thank you, Subco. VPPRC, can you suspend the YouTube and the streaming channels that we are using right now so the NMOs can further discuss this issue if they would like to?
A point of information, Yazid, I did yes. not say that we are requesting it. I just reiterated how the NMOs that requested this today from us can do it on their own and that we are not going to do it and we are not stopping the speakers list. This was just an information because we are going into the same discussion and we were asked today.
Okay, because question. I received other things from the VPE, so I apologize for the misunderstanding. Okay, then we're not going to suspend any streaming and we're going further with that directly to the motion if the explanation from the Supervising Council was enough. Just to make it clear one more time, this is not a formal voting. This is an informal voting and there is no motion. We're going just to have an informal voting so the Supervising Council would use it in their decision of how they're going to plan this investigation that's going to be happening. So again, the options are in favor, against, or abstain. The voting starts now. Please vote. Okay, you have 20 more seconds. Closing the voting now. Okay, it was a close call. We have 70 NMOs who have voted. 28 in favor, 29 against, and 13 abstentions. Again, 28 in favor, 29 against, and 13 abstentions. So I guess that informal voting, whatever it is, the result that the NMOs do not wish to go to proceed the way that IFMSA Morocco has asked for. Okay, so with that matter being closed, I'm going back to the agenda which we had already been started, agenda item regarding the closing ceremony. And we're going now with IFMSA. I received a request from BVMD Germany that they would like to go in last. IFMSA Subco, is that okay with you?
Yes, that is all right with us.
Okay, good. Then IFMSA Supervising Council, you have the floor.
Right. Thank you, Satrias, IFMSA Supervising Council, dear NMOs, dear EBNTO, dear plenary team. We are sad to see this online GA finishing, since we believe that it consisted of fruitful discussions and relevant topics raised. We would not have imagined a couple of months ago that IFMSA would be able to meet at an online setting. And we hereby would like to congratulate the executive board and the team of officials for putting so much hard work and passion into it, as well as the whole plenary team for adapting so well to the situation and making it the best possible experience for us. We believe this is a real precedent for IFMSA, and we are looking forward to meeting you again, either in person or online in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, IFMSA Subco. IFMSA President, you have your hand risen. Is there anything you'd like to say? Is it a point of information?
A statement at the end.
A statement? That would be after BVMD Germany. Yep. That's okay.
Yes.
Okay. BVMD Germany, you have the floor.
Thank you. Dear IFMSA members, dear online GA delegates, dear team of officials, and dear plenary team. At this point of the General Assembly, BVMD traditionally gives the thanks to the organizing committee and hands over some presents. We are deeply saddened that we cannot give something to those who have invested hours and hours in holding this General Assembly, and we still want to spread some love. We would like to thank all NMOs and delegates for participating and contributing to the discussions, debates, and meetings as passionately as in General Assemblies in presence. We would like to thank the Executive Board for the flexibility and dedication to perform almost an entire General Assembly digitally. We all know what it feels like when the pandemic cancels all events, and yet you kept your motivation and aligned a whole GA according to the constitution and bylaws. Even social events were planned, and with Discord you created a social platform and provided us with experiences very close to those of a General Assembly in attendance. We would like to thank the plenary team for their indispensable efforts to guarantee orderly procedures and maintain order in the digital space. The returning officers did an excellent job and guaranteed that all NMOs could vote. Vice Chairperson Yazid, the master of NEMA vote, who made sure that every vote is conducted correctly. And above all, Chairperson Peter, who guided us through the GA and made sure that everything ran smoothly, despite all the changes in the general conditions, all the way through 130 to 140 motions. Finally, there's only one thing left to say. Thank you for giving us this wonderful General Assembly, and hopefully see you soon in Northern Macedonia. Thank you.
Thank you, BVMD Germany, for that sweet, sweet statement. Okay, next we have IFMSA President Nibusha. You have the floor.
Thank you. Just a second to open the correct document.
Just like to make a clarification, we are in the point of regarding the closing ceremony. That would happen after we adjourn the plenary. Is that correct?
Well, I'm giving a closing statement, but the closing ceremony part will happen after the closing, yes.
Okay. You have the freedom to do so.
Okay.
Go ahead. You have the floor.
Thank you. Dear NMOs, this statement means that we're at the end of yet another General Assembly August meeting. 1 year ago, the sentence would not have been as important. 7 months ago, the sentence was what we were looking forward to. 3 months ago, the sentence was what we could only hope to say. This General Assembly meeting has exceeded everything we had hoped it would be. It was far beyond procedural, far beyond the limitations we expected to have 3 months ago when this challenge raised upon us. A General Assembly meeting is not only the chance for the Federation to make important procedural decisions, as proven every time we meet. It is a chance to form the stances of the IFMSA, such as the 19 policy documents that were adopted during this assembly and will guide the work of IFMSA in the coming years. It is a chance for the IFMSA family to grow, to extend our reach, our passion, and our spirit to the ones that just discovered this immersive community. We welcome to our family 5 new member organizations and additionally celebrated the achievements of 3 other member organizations that became our full members. This is a huge accomplishment for IFMSA, but an even bigger one for these organizations. The opportunities that IFMSA gives are now available to an even larger group of students around the world. This meeting is also a unique opportunity for an unforgettable journey. The elections of the future leadership of IFMSA took place during this meeting. We heard the stories and desires of some of the most passionate and inspiring people we have in IFMSA. For years, these members have been working diligently towards the vision of IFMSA, using every opportunity they had to bring us closer to it. This was their chance to be at the spotlight. to inspire us all, and for you to have the opportunity to see that for yourself and the property to decide on the future leadership. We would like to express our gratitude to each and every one of the candidates for the extensive effort they put in preparing the candidatures and for adjusting to the new conditions brought forth by the unfortunate situation in the world. IFMSA is lucky to have you, and we are certain the success will follow you wherever your path takes you next. We might be biased, but seeing you state your approval of reports for all the work done throughout the year by the members of IFMSA was a heartwarming moment for us. Additionally, this was a chance for more members than ever to be involved in the decision-making of IFMSA. During some of the most important moments for IFMSA, we had up to 100 votes from our organizations. This is the highest recorded number of NMOs involved in the decision-making of IFMSA. We're happy to see such involvement by all of you, proving that new initiatives can sometimes have such extraordinary positive effects. The barriers of participation in the most important body of IFMSA have been severely diminished, and we hope that in the future, we can work more on further solving issues that prevent us from having all NMOs of IFMSA participate in the work of the General Assembly. We would like to express our gratitude to the ones that made this possible. Thank you to the plenary team, led by the meticulous attention of the chairperson, Dr. Petar Velikov, and his right hand, Yazid, who brought us back to the basics of the plenary procedures to ensure that no process, no matter how seemingly small, remains unobserved and is done according to every paragraph of the IFMSA Constitution and bylaws. Thank you all for taking up this challenge, for making the first ever online General Assembly meeting possible. We have seen you look at the old problems with a new perspective to bring us the best experience possible, clear decision-making procedures, efficient and well-managed plenaries. We could not have wished for a better team to collaborate with when planning all those details that we take for granted every time we meet in person. In a different setting, even the simplest task of communicating with one another has proven difficult, yet tackled efficiently. We hope to see you again outside of a Zoom plenary room, hopefully admiring your passion for the plenary procedures in person. As the executive board, we would like to extend our thanks to the TIMU officials. In absence of the organizing committee for this General Assembly meeting, we acted as the organizing committee. This meant a lot of things, from the uncertainty of this event even being possible, to extra time being dedicated in order to finalize discussions, to find middle grounds and reach agreements, to not being sure when and how things will be done, not just related to this event itself. It took us all a lot of courage to believe in the ideas we had in order to make this happen. Adapting the content we have been having for years now came at the cost of a lot more effort being invested in preparing for this General Assembly meeting. Congratulations on your efforts to make the best out of the circumstances, and thank you and your teams for your patience as we worked out all the details. All our efforts would not be possible had it not been for so many of our members that joined us and helped shape the direction of the first online General Assembly meeting. Thank you to all our IT members, program coordinators, sessions teams, support persons, and everyone else that helped us in the past months with their input and direct involvement in the creation of this event. And thank you, IFMSA members and NMO representatives. First of all, for your trust in the officials that you elected a year prior, the support and input we received led us to invest countless hours to look into all different aspects of the General Assembly meetings, from procedural to informative to social. 3 months ago, we looked at this event with uncertainty and hope. Now we see it as a reality. You shaped this General Assembly meeting and will continue to shape it in the coming days. It was truly magnificent to see all the efforts invested to accommodate the time zones IFMSA covers. From our friends in the Americas waking up in the early hours of each day, to our friends in Africa, Europe, and EMR that adjusted their daily schedules to dedicate their time, and finally, our friends in the Asia Pacific, who we kept awake until late hours every night. The dedication of every one of you is remarkable and shows our unity in the vision of IFMSA. Thank you also to all the delegates that were reviewing everything shared, even if it was done a half a day prior. Thank you for following and engaging over YouTube as well. Seeing all the love and support you gave to candidates was an awesome sight. Thank you to the representatives that spent time with the plenary team and us every day, 4 to 6 hours per day. In those hours, we lived our lives together, with our minds spread around the world and our hearts where we wanted them to be. Together, we made this possible. Together, we extended the dream of IFMSA to others and conquered one of the biggest challenges we had to this day. We invite all delegations to remain engaged, involved, and supportive of the efforts of over 100 members that are involved in the organization of this General Assembly meeting. There is still one more week, and we are looking forward to seeing you around. Later, there will be time for reflections on how everything was organized and conducted. What lessons have we learned from the General Assembly meeting? What do we want to see in the future? This year, we had two vastly different experiences. We are looking forward to all the takeaways from the meetings and how they will shape the future General Assembly meetings. Stay safe, and remember, now we are just a Zoom call away from one another. Thank you.
Thank you, IFMSA President, for that sweet statement. Okay, so I guess that we are going to move forward. Plenary Secretary, are you still with us?
Yes, I'm gonna copy now the final motion from the motions form. So one moment.
Okay. Can you open your WhatsApp, Plenary Secretary?
Did I receive anything? I couldn't say anything.
Did you receive it?
Yes, we received it. We were going to take 1 minute technical break until we are done with it.
Okay.
1 minute technical break and we're going to the last point in the agenda.
Okay.
I think that we are ready now, right?
Yes. Yes.
Can you share your screen, please?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so for the last agenda item, can you go back one slide up? Okay, the last agenda item, number 59, adjournment of the meeting. Now can we go to the motion? We received the procedural motion from IFMS Executive Board. Number 26, to adjourn the 69th IFMSA General Assembly August meeting 2020, the online General Assembly, proposed by IFMSA Executive Board. IFMSA EB, would you like to explain?
Thank you all. So we have done it, the first ever online plenary, and this is one motion we would not like to propose, but time has come to propose this motion. Stay safe until we meet again. Cheers.
Who are you?
Can you guys hear me? Sanya, IFMSA VPA.
Thank you, IFMSA VPA. Okay, do we have a seconder?
Choose Macedonia, Peter.
I'm not Peter.
Yazid, oh my God. Yazid, yes.
I'm trying to look for them. Oh yeah, I found them. Okay, Republic of Northern Macedonia.
Okay, Republic of Northern Macedonia here. We would like to second this motion.
Thank you, Macedonia. Okay, so I'm going to use the power that we already agreed upon on the guidelines. I am not going for a vote unless we have a direct negative. Please lower your hand, Germany, Macedonia, and Sierra Leone, unless you have a point of order regarding this motion. Okay, so do we have a direct negative? I guess, okay, we have a direct negative. IFMSA Austria, would you like to explain?
IFMSA Austria, we think this would be too sad to not be able to incorporate any more means.
Okay, then, we're going to a vote.
So like I can just say that I'm beating it there.
Okay, so we are ready. Plenary number 8, procedural motion number 26, adjournment of the plenary. You have 3 options: in favor, against, or abstain. And we need 2/3 majority for this motion to proceed. Please vote for the last time. Now you have 1 last minute. Twenty more seconds. Okay, the last vote in this online General Assembly is now closed. And we have 72 animos who have voted, 63 in favor, 6 against, and 3 abstentions. 63 in favor, 6 against, and 3 abstentions. The motion passes with 2/3 majority. Okay, so we are officially closed with the General Assembly. I would like just to take the chairperson's place and thank all the plenary team members that have been working for months to prepare for this General Assembly. Thanking, of course, the chairperson, Dr. Petar Belakov, who had to go to work and couldn't stay with us until the end. The plenary secretary that was working really hard for months now, Mr. Mohammed Mamdouh. Thank you so much for all your hard work. And the secretary assistant, Dr. Aqsa Shafiq from IFMSA Pakistan. Ms. Dina Mariam from MSA India, Mr. Fabian Santiago Cuavero from IFMSA Peru, Mr. Mahmoud Khalid Mahmoud Al-Laythi from IFMSA Egypt, Mr. Tendai Kelvin Sangwimi from ZIMSA Zimbabwe, Mr. Said Rashid Said Sharif from Mets in Sudan, and of course the returning officers who helped us having a smooth plenary, admitting everyone who's waiting in the waiting room or are not voting and they keep on nagging on them to vote. Mrs. Camila Correa from IFMSA Brazil, Ms. Samantha Geraldine from SIMSA Indonesia, and Mrs. Shahd Rashid Said Sharif from Metsin Sudan. Thank you so much. And of course, the people that you love the most, the Constitutional Credential Committee of this August meeting, Mr. Angela Moreno, from Mr. Angelo Moreno, Mr. Gonzalo Diaz Villa, Ms. Hanan Mancour, Mr. Leite Dwekat, and Mr. Michel Naidinov. Thank you so much for all the work that you have put in this IFMSA and this General Assembly. We had been preparing for months, and I should give a special thank for the Executive Board, mentioning the Vice President for Public Relations and Communications, Mr. Saad Shaibi. Thank you so much for all the effort that you have done with us. And of course, the IFMSA Vice President for Activities, Ms. Sania. I apologize, Sania, I couldn't read your final name. thank you so much for all the efforts and all the meetings that we had with both of you to conclude this plenary. And of course, the IFMSA President, Mr. Nibusha. I also couldn't write your last name, sorry. Nikolic, right? Yes, Mr. Nibusha and Nikolic. Thank you so much for all the efforts that you had in order for this plenary. And thank you for all the NMOs that stayed with us, woke up early or stayed up late, or they just skipped a shift in their in the hospital, and they cleared their schedules to be here and decide for the future of our federation. And I hope that we can see you physically face to face, inshallah, in the next General Assembly in the 70th anniversary of IFMSA in March meeting 2021 in Macedonia. Thank you so much. And until then, we all check out.
Thank you,
IFMSA President, you have the floor.
We are proceeding forward, so please don't leave yet. Now is the fun part of the plenaries that we unfortunately had to remove, but we counted on you to help us with this so that we can bring the joy of plenaries. Due to some small technical issues with the video that we uploaded it, I'm going to be shuffling a little bit between them, and I hope you don't mind. So we were supposed to go in order of all the NMOs. Thank you all those that submitted. And I'm going to be playing all those submissions. And we also looked at a couple of them from the past General Assembly meetings. Okay, we're starting with Limsuk Ojeria. Limsuk. Wait, I did not share sound. Where did
I?
Is it working well? Is it? Or anyone?
I think we're actually lagging.
We are lagging a little bit.
You can try.
Can I repeat the part? Is it better?
We are many, and from all the lands on earth we come. We share our dreams and sing with one voice. I am, you are, we are Australia.
Aussie, Aussie, Aussie! Oi, oi, oi!
Bam! Ida, thanks!
Ida! Ida.
IFMSA Belgium, present and voting.
Yo vivo y canto a mi patria, porque la llevo en mi ser. Rojo, amarillo y verde es el tono de mi voz. rojo, amarillo y verde, es el tono de mi mundo.
Adeninha de quê?
De luta!
E adeninha de quê?
De luta!
Adeninha de quê?
De luta!
Serce, dusza,
Slava Bulgaria,
present.
Colombia presente.
We are from a small country in Central America. We are from Costa Rica. Pura vida.
ASEM Costa Rica present.
A kdo neskáče, není Čech! Hop, hop, hop! Kdo neskáče, není Čech! Hop, hop, hop! Present!
When the soca breeze blow, what then lean shall fall?
Money!
Every bad mind, friends and barrier, we shall be moving on.
Hey, hey!
A soca monster.
Soy ecuatoriano, sí, señor.
Y tú eres mi Ecuador.
Ecuador, ecuatoriano.
Con un solo corazón.
Eres mi alma ecuatoriana.
Soy tu sangre y tu color.
Somos dos enamorados.
Tú mi tierra y yo tu flor.
Ahí en pie, Ecuador. ¡Ah!
Okay, this is where we run into technical issues. So we go to the sheet for all your submissions. Ecuador, where are you? Okay, so, yep.
MD German
present.
Mach den Hub, Hub, Hub. Mach den Schrauber, Schrauber, Schrauber. Mach den Helikopter, meins, eins, sieh.
IFMSA Guatemala now. Before that, we had Greece and Germany, if you did not notice.
Present.
Present.
Present. Present. FMSA Honduras.
Un canto.
Did not play well.
Un canto.
Una nación.
Cinco estrellas en el corazón.
FMSA Honduras presente.
Now, MSA India.
Jenga, laka, laka, laka.
Oh, ha.
India.
FMS Iraq. FMSA Kurdistan. Okay, I could not reverse the video like because of this, sorry. Okay, we're starting with the second video, second part of this, with MC Ireland. Yeah, maybe we should have cut this part out. Sorry. Next time.
Chiklem chiklem karotin min jottoro in serpin uril hayatana il maltin. MMSA Malta.
Second, note there was a mistake to Mexico. Ah, right, to download this and play.
By the way, Neboisha, can you close your tabs? Your video doesn't lag. Thank you.
It's not lagging. Okay. Wait, I need to share something else now first. Can you hear the sound? Nope.
No.
No. Okay, I'll try to fix it and play the other ones in the meantime.
Tick, 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 tick,
as a Belgian, present and floating.
Saranda is present.
Okay, from this moment on, there are some technical issues, so can I go back to this? Thank you.
We are Students for Global Health. And I say global, you say health.
Global.
Health.
Global.
Health.
Global.
Health.
Global.
Health.
Global.
Health.
Global.
Health.
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 Health. Health.
Health. Health. Health. Health.
FESOSEM.
Rompiendo barreras.
Uniendo culturas.
¡Wow!
Okay, I have three more that are a little bit harder to reach, so just give me a moment. This is from Sake Kenya.
Simba, Simba,
wah. Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. No passing craze. It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's our problem free.
Sake Kenya present.
Lovely. Okay, let's try Mexico again.
Ay, 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 ay. Canta y no llores. Porque cantando se alegran cielito lindo los corazones.
Okay, and I think it is this one. Well, unfortunately, that is it. We did not receive more submissions, and well, we cannot experience it as we did in the last video. But thank you all for your wonderful contributions. I hope that you enjoyed them, and as we did looking at all of them. And we have one more video now for an announcement for the MIMO Fund. Sanya, do you want to introduce it, or is it already included in the video?
Already in the video.
Okay, so then I will just share the video. Oh, sorry. Wait, who's playing? Yeah, it's gonna play.
Good evening. It's my pleasure to announce the winner of the 2020 Guillermo Martinez Bustamante Memo Martinez Memorial Award. We received many worthy submissions this year and reviewed them with conjunction with the IFMSA Executive Board. And I'm pleased to announce that the winning entry this year is SGP Score Goes Public from CIMSA Indonesia. We congratulate CIMSA Indonesia for their great project on SGP Score Goes Public. During his time as a urologist in Slovenia and even before, Memo had a passion for research, for discovering the truth, for testing hypotheses, for trying to understand the fundamentals that underlined practice, and then to try to apply that knowledge in changing the way we do things in medicine and in health policy and around the world. And so this project really captures the spirit of the Memo Martinez Memorial Award in trying to promote research and an interest in research amongst medical students, and especially the intention of the award funding to ensure that opportunities are shared with medical students and then actually allowing them to participate further. So on behalf of the Memo Martinez Award Committee of alumni, and also together with the IFMSA Executive Board, I want to congratulate CIMSA Indonesia on their awarding of the Memo Martinez Award for SGP Score Goes Public. And I also want to thank all the other NMOs and candidates that sent in really excellent projects that are out there. We know that Memo, as a Secretary General, really supported a lot of projects in IFMSA, and really projects are the lifeblood of the organization, together with exchanges, in really trying to put medical students out there in serving our communities. So congratulations again to CIMSA Indonesia, and thank you to everyone for your wonderful submissions. Please keep up the good work that you are doing. Viva IFMSA.
That was Lawrence Loch, who you heard, or our HLM, who you heard earlier today as well. So that concludes all our videos and the content that we are planning to share. Now remains the last part that presidents of IFMSA usually take care of, and believe it or not, sometime at the end of the term, you actually start to like it. And so I'm gonna go forward with the closing speech followed by the president-elect, and then I will conclude with some final remarks. So stay with us for just a little bit while longer. But, dear IFMSA, a year and a half ago, I sat on a stage in Slovenia. I looked up to see the person asking me the next question, a simple yet brilliant question for any leader. What is your vision for IFMSA in a year's time? My exhausted, preoccupied mind, with all the countless events of the day, could not process a visionary response at that time. I said the most important thing I could think about, and the one that I believed will continuously open the doors for IFMSA to break the wheel and reinvent itself. I said that I envision a powerful and sustainable organization that will utilize the marvels of modern technology to start its next revolution. I see an organization shaped by its extended leadership and members with their vision being the one I will work to bring, or something to that extent. I was not fully satisfied with my answer for quite some time. You don't just say something that seems so near, within reach. That was not the meaning of the word vision I was taught. But as always, I spoke from my heart about what I believed in, and strangely, that often is the correct answer. Months went by since then, and it became increasingly visible that this would not be yet another term in IFMSA. It started with an inspirational speech, a cheer for the term to come. It went past a typhoon, an earthquake, a pandemic, and turmoil around the world. And finally, our journey ends with a success story. Back in March, we all had it in our minds. Each and every one of us heard about the quarantines imposed, the landscape changes across the world, the uncertainty about it all. It materialized in May. For the first time in 69 years, we were canceling the IFMSA General Assembly meeting. I learned about this through my friend. We kept it for ourselves for the night, leaving the rest of the team to sleep for one more night, hopeful for what was there still at the table. I stayed up thinking about the past GAs I attended. It was already the time past IFMSA Moments Challenge. All of the memories swept again through my mind, each and every one of the GAs and their impact on me. What would have happened if one of them was canceled completely? Where would I be? Who would I be? An IFMSA General Assembly meeting is more than an event. It is an experience that alters us, our thoughts and desires, and shapes us to be better than we ever thought we could be. I woke up the day after and wrote an email for my team of officials, one of the most difficult ones I had to do ever. I was not just informing them about the cancellation of an event. I was informing an already devastated team by the situation around us, personally and professionally, their last hope for normalcy in the term was lost. But you do not write a success story by giving up. We do not only accept the responsibility in order to give up when it gets the most difficult. This is what you elected us to do. Tackle in your stead any and all obstacles we find, or at least do our best trying. Trials were on. The first ever virtual team of officials meeting was held, closely followed by the first virtual pre-WHA meeting. Both involved members and externals from all five regions around the world, both with different concepts and ideas behind them. Countless hours later, many spent discussing the nooks and crannies of decision-making in IFMSA. Many spent discussing how to bring the best possible experience for our members. Many spent ensuring that you get to connect to others. And here we are, talking about the success of what we all deemed impossible some time ago. Together, we ensured stability for the organization we love and value so much, and brought to it the marvels of modern technology. We brought on a new perspective to our old ways, a chance to break the wheel and usher a new era in IFMSA as its 17th anniversary becomes closer and closer. A success story indeed. Yet, it is not the one I'm proudest about. In these 2 years, you granted me the opportunity to work with 46 extraordinary individuals, members of a federation that spent a year passionate about their work, the vision of IFMSA, and everything we stand for. This year, the 24 of us, all unique in our own way, worked through everything that was thrown at us. Natural disasters, global health emergencies, drastic changes to the status quo, and the working environment and platforms we never expected. It was all possible because you assembled a team of people in which everyone starts a discussion with the why, moves on to what and how, and thinks of what-if scenarios. Everyone was observing how the concepts we have had working for years were not able to survive the new times, and together with the teams they chose, they looked past the problem and towards the solution. A change only happens if you welcome it with open arms. In a world of dire need for change, you were led by the people that took up the challenges with which changes come. This is what I am the proudest about, to have led a team of such diversity yet such determination to empower medical students and all our other members. As much as I worked with all of them, there's a group that never sleeps. When the night falls on one corner of the world, the sun rises in the other. The days melt into one long day that we all spent together. Some of them were only people I met around the GAs. Some of them were already my friends. They asked me in the beginning of the term, how can I keep on meeting my former EB on a regular basis? Well, how can I not? Over the course of a year, the six other members of the EB have been there for me every step of the way, there to celebrate my successes, there to help me overcome my struggles. We grew together. No matter the difficult discussions, no matter the implications of our discussions, our hearts were always in the same place. Our minds directed towards doing the best we can for the Federation, even if it meant many sacrifices, hours of screen time, missed time with our friends back home, missed time with our families. You elected some of the most capable individuals I was able to work with. It was only on me to ensure we function as a team and that we become a small team and a larger team. I will introduce now the team of officials of the term 2019-20. Starting with IFMSA Vice President for Activities, Samir Hasgabode from MSI India. Can you do spotlights? Or you need to unmute yourself when you get to you. That's Samir. Vice President for Finances, Gabriela De Jesus Cipriano Flores from IFMSA Peru.
Hi, people. What is this music?
Wait, I don't see you on screen. You need to mute if I get too past you. Sonia? All right. Vice President for Members, Paulina Birula from IFMSA Poland.
Hi. I'll just put like works.
I don't know. Yep, there you are. Vice President for Capacity Building, Haider Nouri from IFMSA Iraq.
Maybe let them raise their hand first.
Yeah, not the host. Okay. We're gonna move on. Vice President for External Affairs, Tarek Kazin from Associate in Tunisia. Then Vice President for Public Relations and Communication, Saad Shaibi from IFMSA Morocco. On to our regional directors. Regional Director for the Americas, Maria Jose Jaramillo Cartwright from MP Ecuador.
Hi.
Our Regional Director for Africa, Alistair Shingirai Mukundiva from ZIMSA Zimbabwe.
Hi.
Our Regional Director for Asia Pacific, Bo Chin Lee from FMSA Taiwan. Our Regional Director for the Eastern Mediterranean region, Amr Hamani from IFMSA Morocco. Our Regional Director for Europe, Kita Mihocic from Slomsic Slovenia. On to our Standing Committee Directors. Director of the Standing Committee on Medical Education, Marwan Amzal from IFMSA Morocco.
Hello.
Director of the Standing Committee on Professional Exchange, Gabriela Diaz Silva Dutra from Macedo from IFMSA Brazil.
Hey, y'all.
The Director of the Standing Committee on Public Health, Sarah Maito from Msaki, Kenya.
Hey.
Director of the Standing Committee on Sexual and Reproductive Health and Rights, including HIV and AIDS, Lalo Garcia Valdez, AX Catalonia.
Hi.
Director of the Standing Committee on Research Exchange, Matthew Peer from BEMSA, Belgium. Director of the Standing Committee on Human Rights and Peace, Mahmoud Abdul Amir from IFMSA Egypt.
Hey, all.
A liaison officer to student organizations, Saad Wakas from IFMSA Morocco.
Say, nothing is impossible.
Our liaison officer for medical education issues, Al Dafala from Medicine Sudan. Our liaison officer for public health issues, Omnia El Obrani from IFMSA Egypt.
Hey, everyone.
Our liaison officer for sexual and reproductive health and rights issues, including HIV and AIDS, Egle Yonashanita from LIMSA, Lithuania.
Hello.
Our liaison officer for human rights and peace issues, Tami Yu from IFMSA Taiwan.
Hi, everyone.
Our liaison officer to the World Health Organization, Katja Cic from Slomsic Slovenia.
Hey.
And our members of the Supervising Council, Hanna Lucev from Komsi, Croatia.
Hi.
Sane David from IFMSA NL.
Hi, everyone.
Jan Schenk from BBMD Germany. I'm sure he's here. And Satya Nurshaban from CIMSA Indonesia.
Hello.
Thank you everyone for joining us on our journey. We still have a bit more left. We still have some time to prepare our successors to take over instead of us. I'm sorry that you were not able to meet all the officials in person, that it is only through Zoom screens. But I hope that you will continue engaging in our other content during this General Assembly and that you will be able to meet them all in their respective sessions. That concludes my part of the speech. Now we have IFMSA President-elect Po Chin Lee for the term 2020-2021. You have the floor.
Thank you, Nebosha, and dear animals, dear EB and TO. I think it's very valid to say that this is not the best time we're expecting or we could ever ask for. But I think it's also valid for us to say that when the day we choose to work on global health advocacy or just to do on the public health issues, we are not asking for the best time and the best era to work on. Our life and our work has been severely impacted by the coronavirus 19 pandemic. We are challenged, we are discouraged from this situation, but this is what we need to make efforts for. I am also saying that this General Assembly, we have 36 respectable people from around the world that have the courage that maybe you and I don't even have. They submitted their candidatures to serve further one more year for this federation, even they know they might not be able to travel around the world or the way that we work in IFMSA will be very different. I think they all deserve a round of applause, even though you probably are all unmuted, but these 36 people, they make their efforts during the debate, and that effort start much earlier than that. The composition of candidature, preparation of the presentation, debate, and waiting for the result of the election. This whole process, it's a challenge already. And I want to make this time to thank the 17 of them who are elected, and I want to encourage them that we will try our best to work together and make this challenging time maybe not good one, but memorable ones. With this, I would like to introduce the 23 people that will be working with me in the following term, and I would love to call on their name and their position one by one so you can properly see their faces and know who you can go to in the next year. So we first start with Vice President for Activities elect, Rosanne Saint-Pierre Halon from IFMSA Quebec, followed by Vice President for Finance elect.
Hello, NMOs, how are you?
We have Gabriela de Jesus Cipriano Flores from IFMSA Peru. We also have Vice President for External Affairs elect.
Hello.
She's Egle Janusonite from Limsa, Lithuania. Followed by Vice President for Members elect. Alistair Mukondiva from Zimsa, Zimbabwe.
Hello, hi, how are you?
We also have Vice President for Capacity Building elect, Lucia Agnon Fernandi from IFMSA Spain.
Hello.
And we also have the very lovely Vice President for Public Relations and Communication elect, Amin Yosef Ali from the Souk Algeria. Mm-hmm. And we have all the regional directors. First, we have Regional Director for Africa elect. Oh, we have Matthew first. Okay. This is Regional Director for Asia Pacific, Matthew Xiujun Zhou from IMSA Hong Kong. And we will also have RD Africa elect. Maybe he's not with us. He is Joel Beni-Victoire Anani from AEMP Togo. Next, we will have Regional Director for Americas elect, Javier Shafiq Asfira Kambayalo from IFMSA Honduras. Beautiful face. Then we have Regional Director for EMR Elect, Abdullah Tom from QMSA Qatar. Then we have, hi, Tom. Then we have Regional Director for Europe Elect. She's Mariona Borrell Arasa from ASX Catalonia. Let's conclude Regional Director Elects. We then have SCOMI Director Elect. This is Al Janawi from IFMSA in Morocco. Then we have SCOPI Director Elect, Gabriel Jose Ote from IFMSA Honduras. Next we have SCOF Director Elect, Mohamed Osman Kafa Abdallah from Medicine Sudan. Next we have SCORA Director, Fatma Andrea Rodriguez Osorio from IFMSA Guatemala. Next we have SCORI Director Elect, Veronica Anayansi Vonenzo Maiz from MF Mexico. Last but not least, we have SCOPE Director Elect.
Hello.
Maha Rehman from IFMSA Pakistan. Then we have all the liaison officers elect. First, we have a liaison officer for medical education issues.
Hello.
It's Abdallah Mohamed Abdullahi Rajib Al Kafaji from IFMSA Iraq. Then we have liaison officer for public health issues.
Elect. Hey.
She's Omnia Ibrahim Imnorani from IFMSA Egypt, as you all know already. Orange girl. Next, we have liaison officers for sexual and reproductive health and rights issues, including AIDS and HIV. She's Yeva Berankiete from Lipsa, Lithuania. Thank you very much. Then we have liaison officers for human rights and peace issues, elect. Mahmoud Ahamoudi from IFMSA Egypt, followed by liaison officer to WHO elect, Iris Martin Bloom from IFMSA the Netherlands. Then we will have liaison officers to student organization elect. Okay, this is Iris. Hi, and then this is liaison officer to student organization elect, Nyambura Muroki from Msake, Kenya. We, the 24 people, will be serving you as the next team of official elect, and we are more than happy to also have the support from the supervising councils who will be joining us in the term from Yang Schenk from BVMD, also Sanen De Witt from IFMSA Nederland, James Omid Janani from UNSA Ukraine.
Hello.
Hi, El Tahir Abdelraham from Medicine Sudan, Elina Osi from SMSA Estonia.
Hi.
Hello. Also, Konstantino Theokaris from MSB Bulgaria. We look forward to the close work with you. And of course, we would love to thank and invite the fellow NMOs to join us, comment on our work, and also provide your inputs to our one-year work with all your precious ideas and precious experiences in different fields of the work. I believe that every statement should be awesome if it is short and precise. Thus, I want to thank again the current IFMSA Executive Board members and all the team of official members. You set a very high standard, and your awesome work are the guiding lights for us in the next 1 year. Thank you very much for the legacy, and we wish you to serve you and to see you in person in Macedonia and in Panama next year.
Thank you, Bojin, for an introduction of your TO. I will end with some closing remarks for the whole term. And before that, just a couple of more minutes and we'll invite everyone for the party. Thank you for IFMSA for the grandest of opportunities you could give to any member of IFMSA. To lead the organization of such history was a true honor and pleasure for me. 5 years ago, I was falling asleep at the closing ceremony of my first GA. And today, many fond memories later, I'm doing what I never thought was possible. This organization brings a change in all of us, opens our views to what was once deemed impossible, shapes us to become the people we could always be, what never knew. The memories I made, the values that we have will carry on through me, as is the case with all other IFMSA alumni. You heard many of our former members speaking in our sessions. The friendships they form persevere, and they are there for IFMSA whenever required. And now this goes to all leaders in IFMSA. I know that you didn't expect this. None of us did. When we applied, we had different dreams, different topics we wanted to work on. I know that it is not easy. We all do. It is not easy to deal with the pandemic so close to home. We don't choose what it is to come. As leaders in our own right, we work our best to manage the situation for the best of the ones we are leading. Next period will not be easy. This pandemic is still ever present. I know you're tired. I know you want it to be over and travel and meet all the great people you already met around the world. Participate in amazing opportunities and initiatives, but it will take a bit longer. We need to remain patient and play the cards you're dealt. It is okay. You've gotten this far. You can get further. A friend asked me earlier this year, am I afraid of the pandemic? Am I panicking? Do I know what to do? Sure. Of course I was and still am afraid, but I knew that the people that chose me expected me not to panic, to look into what can be done and had faith in me. I ask you now, at the end, to have faith in yourself as the difficult times come, as did the ones that elected you. I also ask you to have faith in the leadership. The one thing that my team had, or they didn't, was first part of the year, we were able to meet, make all the standard requirements of setting up a team in the working environment. They, unfortunately, will need to deal with the situation from the very beginning of the term. It will require a lot of patience, dedications from all of them, and I wish you all the best of luck and IFMSA in the next year. Thank you all for this General Assembly meeting. And now we're gonna go to the virtual party where we have a special guest to be our DJ, our Vice President for YouTube chat, as he self-proclaimed himself, Fabrizio Canoval, former VPM. I don't know if he is already here, but I think sadly now need to close the YouTube stream and maybe send them a link.
Yeah, like we will adjourn this meeting and we will go to the other link because it's a big room, so it can accommodate all the delegates. Please share the link with your delegates and don't forget the OGA is not finished yet. We still have the theme event with high level experts. We still have the open discussion session and also the standing committee and the NMO management session. So please enjoy and share with your delegates. Thank you.
And activity fair and cross levels.
Okay, thank you so much everyone for having us. Let's go party.